Hello, hello, hello.
Well, hello.
Good evening, everybody. How's everybody feeling tonight? Hello, guy named Kevin, Rico, T. Davis, Kadejito, Random Tees, Hetero Dan, Wayne Pizza, Eddie. Let's see. Clobber, good to see you. Burnout, Channing Vibratum, Agent 86, Many Syllables, No Ruber, Bartek, Lawrence Pikachu, Ivan, Codfisher, Roy Miro-san, Punk Pansy, hello my loathe, Spencer, Roman Numeral 2.
Roman Numeral 2.
I know. Who else? Poop Frog, of course, the illustrious Poop Frog. Been really enjoying your streams recently. Rosemary Walrus. All Might, you are here. I think that's everybody mostly everybody. Wanted to try a little something different tonight. I feel like all my favorite channels have a Jim Roush episode at some point, and I feel like I should be no different. And I brought a friend along for the ride with me tonight. The prolific Kelp Pill. Good evening, Kelp Pill.
Well, good evening to you, Mr. Identity.
Hello, hello. How are you doing?
I am doing quite well, enjoying the happy holy days of Lorne.
Of course, yes. We're all very. Are you giving up anything for Lorne this year?
No, just doubling up on the sacrifices.
Okay, that seems, yeah. You know, that's definitely one way to worship, you know. We all have our own ways. Hello, hello, I'm just being honest. I really enjoyed your stream with Clobber last night. Good to see you. And of course, Cheyenne's Petunias is here. You're just in time. Tonight I thought we would start with the Jim Roush decoy call, because I just find it so entertaining. There's nothing like watching a man, like listening to a man, drive drunk on his way to like sleep with a child, you know? It's a very specific niche, like you don't get to hear it very often, you know? Especially something like recorded like that. It's rare that something like that's caught on tape.
Yes, from the preparation, you know, downing those vodka tonics.
Right, right. Jim Roush is a thirsty boy. That's one thing we can say about Jim Roush.
Very thirsty.
And another thing we can say about Jim Roush is that he did not, in fact, make it to the Sting House to meet with Chris Hansen. He was just caught driving there. He never did make it to Cheyenne, unfortunately. Which, you know, it's sad to see and then just fall short like that.
So close.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, I guess we could just hop right in just to the Roush pool and listen to this phone conversation with the decoy.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi. I bet this is Cheyenne.
Yeah. Not much.
Just about. I'm getting ready to go. I'm getting ready to get on the road.
Cool.
Are you interested?
Yeah, very.
God, he really. At the beginning, he tries very hard to sound vague. Like, he gives it up pretty fast, but at the beginning, he tries to be, like, as vague and, like, tries to make her, he, like, tries to meet her halfway. Like, oh, are you interested? Like, I'm coming to, you know, go for a little drive, if you know what I mean. I just think it's funny how he just doesn't stick to it at all.
You know what? It's sounding that weird way it was sounding before when we were testing.
The robotic way? Like, the way you're listening to the call, you mean? Okay, let me, I guess I'll just reset it on here then for you. Can everybody else hear, does the call sound okay for you guys? Just checking. But I'll reset it in your window.
Thank you. I'm just a troublemaker.
Okay.
Okay.
Phone conversation with Decoy. There we go. And I'll try it again.
Hey.
Yeah.
Yep.
I'm just like scared there's gonna be somebody over there like the cops and everything.
No, it's just me.
Okay, well, 140 what, Kevel?
Yep.
Okay, well, I will be there as I'm at my place right now, and I'm it's like Eastgate area.
Okay.
And I will be there as soon as I can be there.
Okay.
Are you sure this is okay?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Okay. Well, I will be. What?
Do you want me to make you some juice or something for when you get come over?
No, I said I'm like a black and tonic. I'm fine.
it's almost as if to like cement in Jim's head that this is a child that he's talking to, as if the voice wasn't enough. Yes. And I love how he's like, right, juice and, you know, yeah, maybe some cookies. Yeah, I mean, yeah, all the stuff they usually have at those houses. But yeah, I also think it's you know, he does the normal predator thing of like trying to put it on the kid. Like, you know, is this okay with you? Like making sure it's okay with her, as if to like alleviate some guilt in their own head.
He's trying to make his conscience as clear as he possibly can in thinking that a minor can give consent.
Right. They do a lot of mental gymnastics.
Fine. I'm fine. I'm okay.
Okay.
And I will be there as quickly as I can get there. I've got a couple things to finish up here before I leave the house, and then I'll be right over there.
Those are famous last words.
Is there anything I should know?
As I can.
Is there anything I should know?
I'll be right over there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
About the house or anything, you said. I said, okay. Let me think through this. Okay, I get off 471, turn on 27, first street on the left. I don't know what the name of that street is, and then the right, and then the left, and that's Kevel.
It's 140 Vogel, V-O-G-E-L.
Oh, Vogel. I don't know why I said Kevel. Okay, it's 140 Vogel. It's okay. What do I turn off of 127? Off of 27. What's that road? Do you know?
Ooh.
Never mind.
I'm not sure.
It's the first one. It's the first one. It's the first one.
Yeah.
Okay.
You want me to call you in a little bit just to make sure you have the right direction?
I'll tell you what. You
This is something that it says a lot in the comments section of this video, but I think it's really funny that like Jim never questions the 13-year-old with like the knowledge of the highways and streets like of a seasoned cab driver, just like making his way down like it's no big deal. Like what 13-year-old doesn't know how to get to her house from like I-95?
And can name every visual landmark along the way.
Right. Do you know the Lowe's Home Improvement? Like, yeah, okay.
You call my cell. I've got your phone number on my cell now. If I need you, I'll just like back up on that.
Okay. I don't know. It's at the dead end. It's a dead end street.
Okay.
So it should be pretty easy to find.
It's on the left hand side. 140 is.
Yeah, you turn down Camp and then you make a right on Vogel.
Okay. Turn right on Vogel, and is there a sign or a mailbox or something?
The house number should be fairly easy to spot.
Okay. Well, if I have a problem, like I said, I've got your number. You sure this is okay with you? This is okay with you? Okay.
This is okay with me. I'll call you, though, because I don't know. My mom might have myself my incoming calls blocked, but I can call you.
Okay, well, I like I said, within the next half hour or so, I'm heading my way over there.
Okay.
And I would. I'm really looking forward to this.
I am too.
Yeah. Yeah. Sounds real good.
I will give you a call in a half an hour. Okay.
Okay, and if I may pull up your driveway before that half hour, because I'm just about ready to leave here.
Okay.
Okay. I'll see you in a little bit.
Yeah.
Bye-bye. Hello.
Hi.
Hi, I am at. Okay, I'm telling you where I'm at, because I'm at Antonio's Wine, Liquor, and Beer Tobacco.
Ah, another famous line. Antonio's Wine, Liquor, and Beer Tobacco.
Okay, I'm looking for a left-hand turn. Where does it pass the church?
I don't remember a church.
Okay, it's called, I can't tell. I'm going down the hill now. I'm going to turn around and come back up. I'm ready to see you, okay?
Mm-hmm. Okay,
there's a stop sign here. Is this the office?
The what?
The office, and then there's the cottage, cocktail lounge.
You know what the decoy means.
By what?
Google Earth.
Oh, Google Earth, of course.
So she can just see, Jim on the road and see how he's,
right.
Making
right. It makes monitoring people a lot easier when you have the power of Google Earth. Yeah.
Parkway? It's right across from...
I'm turning around, okay? I got a feeling I went too far, okay?
Okay.
God, like the first time I heard that, like I thought maybe that would like be the end of it. Like he was turning around to go home, but no, he's just turning around. He just wants to give it another shot. He's like, no, I'm still coming. Nothing will deter me.
I went past the cottage cocktail lounge, the office, and I'm going up the hill. Oh, I hope the hell you have a bathroom because I need to piss.
Okay, the church. Well, what church is it?
Jesus Christ.
What?
What's the name of the church that you're passing?
Oh, shit. There's no sign out front.
What's it look like?
What?
What's it look like?
Oh, it's a big church. There's Antoine's Wine and Beer.
You go past the church.
He's back at the Beer Tobacco.
I go past the church?
Yes.
That means a fucker here to turn around. Okay.
I'm sorry.
That's not a problem. I can do it. I'm a damn good driver. Okay, go be careful.
Bullshit.
Jim is one of those people who I hate giving instructions to because he acts before you finished giving like the full instruction.
Right, because he thinks he knows what you're going to say. He's like, oh, no, I get it.
Right.
I'm Jim, I understand.
He'll start clicking, before you finish telling him what to do. And I'm sure, and when he's driving, he's not even really, he only listens to her in the beginning.
Right.
And then you think he has it, and he starts going.
Then it turns out he fucking doesn't.
Yes.
I've gone to the wine, and okay, now here's the church. I'm back to the church.
Okay, hold up there.
Hold up. There's a green light here at the church. I'm now going down the hill.
Right, okay. Clobber. It's like Jim Roush can only, like, the only landmarks he knows in his real life are just, like, liquor stores and tobacco stores. So those are the only ones he really notices while he's driving. Especially when he's drunk, when, like, all of his senses are dulled. He's just, like, working on instinct. So all he really, he's like, oh, liquor, beer, tobacco, That's just,
what does he
that's
consider Pompilios?
Pompilios, I think, food. Food seems to be the thing that Jim enjoys, And getting his dick sucked, which happens frequently at Pompilio's.
Yes, so I hear.
Okay. You're looking for Alexandria Parkway.
I don't think so.
What do you mean you don't think so?
I'm probably on Alexandria Parkway.
Oh, are you?
I'm guessing. Here's the office. I'm back to the office. I'm at the red for the light here.
You want?
he just like follows the scent of alcohol, like an old cartoon, like it leaves, and he's just following it with his nose.
Forms a little finger.
Right.
27. Are you on
27? I got a feeling this is. I think I'm on 27. I really do.
Okay, you want to keep going straight.
Okay, I'm here at Transfer Station Sportswear. Big Lot?
Captain Big Lot? Lot, it's 5 miles. Just keep going straight.
It's what?
About 5 miles. It's about five miles.
Oh, shit. Okay. Making a big circle. Oh, shit. You better damn well have a someplace spoon with piss.
Oh, what's going on? Lauren Vignettes, Shins Koala, David, Mike Scott. Good to see you all.
I have a bathroom. Why wouldn't I have a bathroom?
This is the first of a couple times where the decoy gets like genuinely annoyed with Jim. Like, why wouldn't I have a fucking bathroom? Like, Jim? Why wouldn't I have a fucking bathroom, Jim?
Okay, I'll tell you the places I'm seeing. Papa John's, here's, Sherwin-Williams.
Have you passed a Lowe's?
Please?
Have you passed a Lowe's?
Sherwin-Williams, please? Like, he's like, please let this be right.
Have I passed the what?
Lowe's.
The what?
Lowe's store. The Lowe's Home Improvement.
No.
Oh, wow. Someone in here named Lorne's Mom's Camel Toe. That is pretty intense. That's a really aggressive username. Unlike the
Brings
one below you, Spider-Man.
Image, huh?
Right. We also have Spider-Man in the house, obviously. In Johnny, Utah.
Hello,
no, I don't.
No. Okay, once you see the Lowe's.
There's a Lowe's. I'm coming to a Lowe's.
Okay, it's first street.
I'm sorry. I'm coming to a McDonald's.
You're coming to a McDonald's. Okay. Once you get to Lowe's, it's the first street on the right.
There's a street here on the right?
Yeah, but
that's
once you...
Okay?
No, it's at Lowe's. You have to pass Lowe's first. Not
okay.
McDonald's. You have to pass Lowe's.
Okay, I see a White Castle. Am I confusing you?
No.
Okay.
Keep coming, because you're going to see a Lowe's. You're going to see a Lowe's Home Improvement store. After you see the Lowe's...
I have not seen a Lowe's.
I see a
Kmart.
Yeah, Jim, close enough. Just go to the Kmart.
It's Kmart. Keep coming. It's about 5 miles. It's great.
Why don't you tell me downtown Cincinnati?
Huh?
Why don't you tell me since downtown Cincinnati?
What's going on? Torn Ligament, Grim Reap 1. How are you?
It's okay. Hey, listen to me.
What?
CNJ Dev.
If you can do what we're talking about, I'm driving.
Okay, man.
Gentlemen. Jim.
Yeah, calm down. You're like, well, it's like, you know what? This will all be worth it if you'll fuck me. Just saying. Cool, man.
You suck my dick. It's all going to be worth it.
Right. No, that's exactly what he means. If you're willing to give me oral sex, all this confusion will have been worth it for me. Like, thank you for clearing that up for us, Jim. I think we know that.
Got me?
Yeah.
God! Somebody does, because we're down in Newport. Does that make sense? I get a piss, though. God, I get a piss bad.
I have a bathroom. Just keep coming.
Yeah, but when I get it. Gourmet chili.
You're
I don't think
it's
going
up
right.
Soon.
From what the directions you gave me, Dixie Chili. I'm going by Dixie Chili right now.
Dixie?
I am on new... What?
Dixie what? Chili? You're going the wrong way.
I figured as such. I guess I may have to stand off from the road and piss off. Piss. What do you think? Do you think I should go stand on the side of the road and piss?
No, just keep coming. Just keep coming. I have a bathroom. I'll open the door for you and you can run into the bathroom when you come.
Where do you go to school?
Huh?
Where do you go to school?
I go to school.
The local school.
Oh, wow. Okay, first of all, him asking her that, like, was clearly a test. Like, he was clearly trying to test her to see if she'd be able to, like, see it. But then she got it wrong. Fuck that up completely. She said the local school, and he still, like, didn't pick up on it. He still just, like, he chose not to hear that.
Yes, because he's preoccupied with an entirely different idea than what school she goes to.
Right, of course. He doesn't really care. He just wants to, like, make the gesture of, like, trying to be cautious.
Right. He can say, I asked her.
Right, exactly. Like, oh, I asked her if she wanted it, and, you know, she enticed me, which is what he says over and over in his goddamn interrogation, which is just as infuriating as this.
I flustered you as big as they.
You did.
I know I did. Hey, listen. It's not a big deal. I'm really worried about, you know, this legal thing.
There's nothing to worry about.
Oh, so Heisenberg is an alumni of the local school. Good to know. Prestigious.
Can I fuck you and you're still 13?
Oh, yeah. Well, there it is.
You think?
Yeah.
Oh, what's going on? Well, if it isn't intent... Nice to meet you. Very cool, Jim. Very good. I really like when the Predators are, like, very explicit, like, with their intentions, like, in phone calls, or, I mean, in chats is one thing, but, like, phone calls, too. It's, they're, like, really blinded by this singular purpose.
Yeah.
I
don't even know what to say.
Yeah, it's...
If you don't tell anybody, I don't tell anybody, you know?
Okay. We'll go from there, okay? Oh, some guy's come out to my car. Scotty's got a afro thing on. Okay, where am I going?
Okay, did you turn around?
I'll tell you where I'm headed, and you can tell me from there.
Okay,
if I piss in my car, I will piss out my windows, okay?
Huh?
If I have to piss out my wings, I will. Okay. I am down at Newport. Right now.
Down at Newport. Okay, you need to turn around and go the opposite way. You need to...
Okay, I need to go out of way away from Newport. Newport. I understand that. Okay, and I will do that. Unless I can't, which is another... I always have a bottle or something. I'm sorry. Does that tell you how crude I am? Okay. I just went by
house. Don't really have to tell me how crude you are, Jim, after... Can I come and fuck you even though you're 13? I think that's, you know, pretty solid evidence.
He doesn't say that's crude. It's the, you know, wanting to piss in a bottle that he thinks is
crude. Oh, no, but like, that's the point where he says it's crude. Right, yeah, exactly. Yeah. That's what he's embarrassed to say. He's like, oh no, please pardon me. Bo, by the way, can I fuck you even though you're 13? LOL.
That is classic, Jim.
What?
I just went by the Hopra House.
What? You went by the Hopra House?
Yes, in Newport.
You're in Newport? Okay, did you turn around?
Did I turn? I'm gonna get back on 7. I'm gonna get back on 471.
You want to go the opposite way on 27. You went into Newport, so you want to turn around and go the opposite way. You want to pass all the stuff that you pass. You want to pass Papa John's?
Right, right. I understand. But if I go on 471, I can bypass all that, right?
I don't know that way.
Okay. Where can I get off 471 to get to you?
Oh, just turn around.
Okay, I'll do that.
I'm sorry, what was that, Jim? Ha! Nah!
Random vocalizations.
Huh? Yeah, cool. Hello, Amanda James.
I'll do that. Just because, you know. Okay, I'm turning around.
Oh, and of course, both Whoopie Pie and Cookie Whoopie Pie. Good to see both of you.
Okay. I may stop at it like a... You know what? Can you hold on for a second while I piss my brains out?
Oh, my God. sorry. Did he not mention he was a little crude, a little crass?
You like that? Hey... Damn it, Cheyenne! How do you get a damn name like Cheyenne and be and live in Newport?
I don't know.
and your real age is 13?
Yeah.
You sure you want to fuck that?
Oh, God. Oh, yeah. Come on.
Okay. Okay, I'm at the...
Again, he's just trying... I guess his own maybe short or what's the word? Hesitations or yeah, right. His conscience, I guess. But like, oh no, at least I asked her. You know, it's okay if she says, you know, she says yes. The 13-year-old.
Oh, yes. Fuck, what is this? What a Tommy Square, whatever. I'm at the corner where actually my daughter. Oh God, this is crazy. My daughter.
It sure is. It sure is freaky, Jim.
Was a good movie at Pompilio's.
Uh oh.
Have you ever been to Pompilio's?
Uh oh.
No.
I don't know. I don't think so.
Hey, yeah. You ever said pick a Pompilio's?
Oh, Jim. No. There it is. Jim. You said the thing. You said the thing I hate, Jim. You said it. You said the thing I really don't like.
That line.
And, breaking up, is that what we call that? No. Okay, I'm driving up toward... We're going to get there before your mother gets home, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And come on, you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. I like
this on the phone, by the way. I'm going to stop over back and I'm going to piss my brains out. I got to piss if I don't. I will call you back in a minute, okay?
I'll call you back in a minute, okay?
Okay, fine. Bye-bye.
All right, bye.
Hello?
Hi.
Is this Cheyenne?
Yes, sure is.
Hey, how are you?
I'm okay, where are you?
What if you're just like, no, who's this?
I'm in South Gate. In South Gate.
South
Gate? Yeah, come on, stay with me, okay?
I'm
back where, you know, where I said the office was before.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. I'm going back out Dixie Highway.
Yes, that's a very good point, a guy named Kevin. He... has said the phrase piss my brains out more times than he should in any conversation with anyone, not just like a little kid, with anybody. Don't say piss your brains out. Just don't say it.
I'm coming out to fuck you, okay?
Mm.
And I just went by that church we talked about before.
Okay, it's about 5 miles.
About five, I'm going toward... 271.
Mm-hmm. Keep going.
Does that make sense? I'll give you another landmark here. Fisher Homes. There's a car dealer right here. 16,
Fisher Big Boy?
Please?
Chris, big boy?
I still couldn't understand you.
Have you passed Frisk, big boy?
Frisk's boy, big boy? I have not passed that, no.
Okay.
Okay, I'm coming up toward where your mother probably works, probably.
Truly, no rubber. This is a thought crime. Spies are and have been listening.
Up that is the true. Southgate Hospital, wherever that is.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm on. I don't know what the hell the road I am on. If this, hey Cheyenne, if this didn't work out, it doesn't mean I'm not trying. I am really trying.
Oh,
don't worry, Cheyenne. I am really, really trying to fuck you here. I'm really trying to break the law here,
really
Cheyenne.
Trying.
Please don't worry. Yeah, don't worry, Cheyenne. Dude, don't think for a second that I'm not trying.
I have a
Nobody
question
thinks
for you,
that, Jim.
Identity.
Yes, please.
What do you think? How many additional cocktails do you think Jim brought with him as he was driving to Cheyenne's?
What I think is that Jim took like one of those thermoses that you usually put like a soup in. Like maybe he took it like to a gig or something when he knew we wouldn't be eating for a while. But I think he put like gin and tonic in there and like a couple of like half limes and just like threw it in his cup holder. That's what I think he's doing.
I think that's very possible.
But I guess they would have found that in his car. I don't know. Maybe he was just chugged a few before. But like, yeah, like if he'd had the drinks in his car, would they have found it when they searched the fucking car?
Well, he could have thrown them away when he stopped at.
That's true. Then maybe it was something disposable. Maybe it was just like a plastic cup that he had and just made a cup like a big, like one of those big disposable cups.
Like, yeah, like
you find like a convenience store,
from like a 7-Eleven. Yeah,
sure.
That's
yeah.
What I see.
Yeah, and then just toss it out the window before he gets pulled over or something, or at some point along the drive. Whenever he finishes it anyway.
Doing that.
Yeah.
Then he wishes he could have pissed it. So.
I know. Yeah. Yeah. That's a good point. Yeah. But no, he's definitely drinking a little bit more throughout this because he's still like audibly drunk.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What?
My mom isn't coming till like middle of the night, 3 a.m.
Okay, maybe we have the middle of the night to fool around. Okay.
Oh, good, yeah, cool. You have the middle of the night to fool around.
There's some buildings here out in front. I know this is where you turn to go to the old Beverly Hills. That's where I'm at, okay? Moore's.
There you go, kind of having a big sheets cup. That's. That's someone speaking from experience.
Lumber and Hardware. I'm driving up this way. Oh, almost ran off the road.
Uh-oh.
Okay, where am I going?
Uh-oh. Whoopsie. Whoopsie, Jim. Be a shame if you were to get in some kind of accident. That hurts nobody but you.
What'd you like for me to do?
What road are you on? Where's that?
I don't see any road signs, but it's off of 471. Okay.
Have you passed Wilson Road?
I'm at past what?
Wilson Road.
No, I don't know what that is. I'll tell you what I'm coming up to, and that'll help me out. Oh, it's pretty, whatever it is. Let's see, what does it say? Dance impressed. Shit, I can't tell what the fuck it is.
Oh my god.
Northern Kentucky Service.
That's the thing. I guess like he would have just like had to have printed out like a map quest or something and just had it in the car with him and hope for the best.
Yeah. Back then.
Yeah. Oh, Jim. Poor Jim.
I know you don't know these things. I'm on 27.
What's going on, DJ Xander Digital, Pam Simpson? How are you guys doing?
Heading toward, away from 275. Heading away from 471. I can get on 471. I know how to do that, okay?
Okay, get on 471.
Okay. I'm going to turn around.
Wait. Have you passed Southgate? Fort Thomas exit?
I'm turning around right now. I'm going to 471, and I'll head toward 275. 471 to 275.
Now you want to head south on 27.
Okay. Well, I don't know what I'm on 27. I don't know where the south, north, west, east. It looks
have
like.
Have you passed the bowling alley? What are you by right now?
He only sees liquor stores. You got to stick with liquor stores, Cheyenne.
Apartment buildings. There's something over here on the left. Let me see what that is.
Is that a bowling alley?
No. It's like a home or something. Okay. It says I'm going, welcome to Southgate.
Okay, that's where you want to be. You want to get off at Southgate Fort Thomas exit. And you want to take a right heading south on 27.
On 27, I'm on 27.
You're on 27? So you're heading the right way then. Okay, stay on that.
Yes, Freakin' Reekin, I wish you Jim Roush levels of intoxication. And minus the pedophilia, of course.
Okay, I've got that.
You'll pass a bowling alley.
I haven't seen the bowling alley yet, but you know, us guys have to piss them thing. I haven't seen bowling alley. You're supposed to laugh, damn it!
I did laugh. I giggled.
Okay. I'm crossing under 471. I'm on 27, going towards Cincinnati, and I'm under 471, and there is a, I don't know what it is, car dealer over here on the right. Does that help?
What car dealer? Is it first?
I assume it's a Jeff Weiler, but I can't. Yeah, it's a Weiler. It's a Weiler of some sort. I'm coming to a yellow check. Like, there's this Fisher Homes in Pyramid. Okay, let's stop.
Wrong way!
Wrong way?
Wrong way, Jim!
You know how to get on...
Jim. Nice try.
471.
Yeah, right here, I certainly do. North or south.
Okay, hang on. I'm trying to think of where you are. Give me a minute.
I'm on... Okay, I just turned... I'm on the 471. Oh, shit. I may have turned the wrong way. Oh,
you
want
to go on 27?
I have to piss somebody
away. You, Jim, turn the wrong way? Never.
No. That does not sound like Jim at all. And yeah, seriously.
I sent you a bunch of photos. Oh,
you did?
Courtesy of Joey's TCAP channel.
Are they on Skype? Are they Discord?
On Discord.
Okay.
And you are free to share those as you will.
Oh, fantastic. Yeah, I think I will. But yes. Yeah, exactly, Rosemary. This 13-year-old should be a cab driver when she gets her license. Yeah, I'm going to take 471 at 276. 471 at 275, you know. Just get you there on time. And yeah,
and she doesn't sound like a sad Cheyenne.
No. And yeah, hetero Dan, invest in a GPS. If he's got all that, you know... money from the University of Cincinnati doing all that work for her. He may as well invest in a GPS. Get to the Sting House on time. I really wanted to see a Chris Hansen, Jim Roush interview. Really missed out.
Away from Cincinnati on 27.
I figured that, but I don't know what the hell I turned on. Never mind. I know what... Just becoming defeated.
No, I want to see you.
Okay, then I will keep on working on it. I will keep on working. I'm going to turn around and go back up because this does not look very good. I'm down here and the bears are looking for my dick.
Uh-oh.
I'm sorry. Wait, what? What did he say?
You're funny.
The bears are looking for his dick? Is that what he says?
I believe that is what he said.
The bears are looking at... But, like, did I miss the did I miss some context for the bears looking for his dick?
There is zero context, I believe.
Oh, God. I need to hear that again.
I'm looking for my dick. Down here, and this does not look very good. I'm down here,
and
the bears are looking for my very good. I'm down here, and the bears are looking for my dick.
The bears are looking for my dick. Yeah, that's. I don't know what else it could be.
Is that a problem in that part of the country?
I think so. Maybe like in the Cincinnati, in like the greater Cincinnati area, they have like a bear problem, and the bears always are looking for human dicks to tear off.
Maybe it's not animal bears.
Oh, maybe you're thinking maybe it's like the Chicago Bears?
Not Chicago Bears.
Oh, the gay kind.
Yeah.
Fun. Oh, maybe. You know, they could be looking for his dick. He that is his demographic. Though. Yeah.
That's right.
Right. There are probably some bears in the Swingers Club too that he could leave with if he wanted to. If he didn't
but
walk
he right out,
right and out. Kept an open mind, you know. Come on, Jim, broaden your horizons.
Uh-oh, that's not good.
Live a little.
I like you. You're funny. You're funny.
She's really not. She's just like really trying her best to get you to the house, and you're like doing everything in your power to not go to the house.
So you are. I don't know where the hell I'm going, but I love it. And you know what? For a Friday night or Saturday night, this is like fun. What do you do? Normally? Oh well, I take guys around. I'm playing around. I'm going back to 275. You know what? The bottom line is, I'm gonna find out where the fuck you are, and I'm gonna take you to my house. And I'm gonna fuck your brains up.
Oh my fucking word. That's pretty bad. That's pretty bad.
I never noticed that he said, I'm going to take you to my house.
Yeah, this is like...
I've never noticed that before.
He's another dude like Lorne who like wanted to pick them up and bring them back to whatever, you know, hovel they live in.
At least Jim had a bed.
Yeah, Jim definitely had a bed. Lorne decidedly did not have a bed. That's, Yeah, you know, then I guess that makes it okay. At least you're out of bed. But yeah, no, that's pretty crazy. Like, I can't imagine, like, what's the end game there? Like, they're trying to, like, he was going to take her back, fuck her brains out, and then bring her all the way back to her house before her parents noticed? That was the idea? Like, that seems like unnecessary risk. That seems like, do you want kidnapping and like missing persons report and like hostage situations on top of what you're already doing?
But he got her consent.
Oh, right. You know what? I keep forgetting. He asked her if it was okay and she said yes, so.
Exactly.
No, yeah. Thank you for keeping me on track.
Toast is clear.
Yay!
You think?
Yeah!
You know what? You know, all the conversations you have kept away from that.
Kept away from it? What do you mean kept?
Yeah, you never said you wanted to even look at me.
I'm nervous though, you know?
I'm telling you what I observed.
I know.
But it's cautious. I don't blame you. That's the same cautiousness I have. Shit. If anybody find out that I was talking to a 13-year-old, God, they would fire me like left and right. Okay. I'm back. I am back to the car dealer.
Okay, are you on 27?
It's 27.
Okay, are you back on 27?
Right. It says 27, not 127, 127.
Okay, you want to
if I turn...
You want to be on 27 heading away from Cincinnati.
Okay, I got that. Good.
Okay. Okay, same... 127.
Okay, same wave track. Same wave track, and you know we're going to run out of time, and we're not going to have to do a chance to do this, aren't we?
Oh, no. If you take too long, you won't have enough time to fuck her, Jim. Better hurry up.
I gotta get to that sexual assault.
Right. Don't want to be late to your statutory rape.
I'm trying. Okay, now I'm back here at this intersection of 471.
Okay, is there a bridge?
No, it's just 471 north, 471 south, or 275. Turn it right.
Hang on. Where are you?
I just turned on to 27.
South or north? Are you going away from Cincinnati?
Yes.
Okay, you're on 27?
I was.
You're going to Cincinnati, right?
I'm going away from Cincinnati.
Okay, you're still on 27, though, right? Quit confusing me.
Well, I'm at an intersection.
At an intersection?
Yes. Yeah. Now, there's a sign up here that says north Cincinnati, turn to the left. I know where this road is. I know where this is. I'll go to my place.
Yeah, Eddie, he really knew how to make things easy for the DA's office, didn't he? I'm coming to fuck you, Cheyenne. I hope you're ready for my penis. Cheyenne, are you sure you want to fuck me, although you are 13? Cheyenne?
Cool, he does, Jim. He does mention her age, even.
Mention her age, yeah, quite a bit. doesn't look good, James.
We'll work out this. I know where I'm at.
You know where you're at?
I know where I am. I don't know where you are.
Okay.
Okay, I'm on 471, heading toward 275 at this point.
275? Okay, you got off the 20.
I'm heading on 7. I'm on 471, heading south. I'm just trying to give you two, and that I can turn around. It's not a major deal. I got a plank leg of gas. It's not a problem. I'm coming up. To 47, I'm coming up to 275, and I can make decisions. Okay, think about it.
Where are you coming from?
I am going toward 275 right now. I am on 471. I'm heading toward 270.
Yeah, seriously, CNJ Div. Jim could not be more annoying right now. Like, yeah, go to a gas station and ask. Do anything. Do fucking anything else besides what you're doing.
75, and I can make a choice of whether I want to go back toward Newport or go toward wherever the hell that is. Just tell me where you think would be best.
You're on 471. Are you going?
I am 471. About to get off of it, but go ahead.
You're stopping. Okay. Wait. Don't do anything. Are you passing any businesses?
No. I'm on expressway. There's no businesses out here. I can turn around and can come back by way of. It's not a problem. Go ahead. Tell me where I need to go.
Okay. You want to. 471. Okay.
I am 471. Now I'm okay. Let's cool 471. I am now on 275, headed east.
God, this is just mind numbing. Like this middle part here just gets like he's so stupid.
And he never stops. So even though she's trying to sort out where he is, by the time she can come up with something, he's already way past.
He's somewhere else.
Point.
He like never stops moving, right?
He never just keeps pulls over.
Any other person would have pulled over. Like he gives her this stream of consciousness too. It's just like never ending. It's just like talking her into a vortex. You know, it's kind of the way Lorne does, except he's doing it, you know, not on purpose.
I can go over the river, come back, and go 275 west. It's not a big deal, okay?
Okay, like hang on. I'm trying to picture in my mind where you are.
Okay. Do you know where 275 is?
I think so,
275
yeah.
Goes around Cincinnati, and I'm headed, and I'm at this point, I'm headed towards the Ohio River, and if I keep on going, I will cross over the Ohio River and hit Kellogg Avenue. And
what's going on, Cthulhu Hen Luke? And Poop Frog. I don't know if I read Poop Frog, but you know he'll get a second one. Blop blop.
I don't.
He's deserving.
Why not?
Tell me where to go.
You want to go away from Cincinnati?
It's kind of hard to do since I'm on the outskirts of Cincinnati.
Yes, David McGarry. He's already past Antonio's liquor, wine, and beer tobacco.
I can go back into Cincinnati if that's what you like. I'm not being facetious. I'm just telling you.
Yeah,
I know where I'm at.
Okay.
Listen. Do you want to fucking?
Yeah.
Of course, another check-in to clear his conscience. Cool. hello, sorry, sip of water. Hello, Roy. He weren't 10. That's a new one.
That's a great one.
Yeah.
Okay. If this doesn't work out tonight, there is always. Are you doing something tomorrow?
I don't know my mom's work schedule. This is an idiot.
Let's get this worked out if we can. I'm at Kellogg Avenue. I can turn around.
Okay, hang on. You want to turn around on 275 and hit 471 south. You're like 3 miles. 3 miles
okay.
From
you. Okay, I can do that. 3 miles from you?
Yeah, you're like you 3 miles from me.
I am doing. I'm taking off Kellogg Avenue right now. Okay?
You're taking what Avenue?
I'm going off Kellogg Avenue right now. I'm going to turn.
So, sounds like he's saying Chatlog Avenue.
Turn around and go back 275 to south 471, and you said 3 miles to what?
You're 3 miles from me. You're like 3 miles away from me.
Yeah, and it's not getting any harder right now.
I'm sorry, David Gaffney said something particularly, has painted a picture, as it were.
Please.
He put in the chat, play my hymen like a banjo, please, Jim.
Wow. I mean, I'm sure Jim now would take you up on that offer. I can't imagine many people are talking to him these days.
quite a picture there, David. Thank you.
Yeah. Also, ew, David. You nasty, David.
Harder? Yeah, you want a harder?
Yeah, you're
circles,
though.
No thank you, Jim.
I'm just giving you a hard time. I don't have anything else to do tonight, so I'll give you a hard time, right?
You sound
so up. God, I wish I was up as much as you are.
Are you kind of
What do you think that means?
I think he's talking about like she's like her disposition. Like I think Jim is probably most of the time pretty a depressed guy.
Right. So you're saying it's just like you're so much like happier and like more bubbly than I am, and I wish I was like you, other little girl. Jim wishes he had a more like little girl-like demeanor.
Yes. He's just a pack of barrettes away from that type of happiness.
Of course. One more gin and tonic and you'll get there, Jim.
I'm from Kentucky or Ohio.
What?
What?
I am going from... Oh, shit. God, I almost wrecked this guy. This ram is standing around. I was so excited about listening to you talk.
So it's the second accident he's almost gotten.
What was that?
Well, he almost ran off the road a little bit ago, and now he's saying that he almost hit a guy.
Oh, yeah, no, he's he honestly is lucky that, like, all he did was get pulled over and arrested for trying to fuck Cheyenne. Like, he could have hit somebody. He could have killed somebody easily that night.
Like,
making U-turns. Yeah, I can't imagine that every U-turn he was making was legal, you know?
Oh,
yeah, exactly. Sorry, sip of water. I'm drunk driving, little girl.
I gotta piss again. And I only pissed once. Oh.
And now he's gotta piss again. This is not looking good for Jim.
Shit! What the hell am I gonna do now? Okay.
Where are you coming from?
Okay, Shin says he drinks vodka tonics. I'll defer to Shin in terms of, you know, teacup lore. Vodka tonics it is.
I am coming from the bridge!
Okay, but Kentucky or Ohio?
I am coming from Kentucky. I am in Ohio, and I'm going to turn around somewhere, if it'll let me. And I'm going to turn right here, which I think I can do. And I'm going to come to Kentucky, and I'm going to come and fuck you.
Okay, you want to go on 275 and then back to 471 south.
You got it. I understand. That's exactly what I'm doing. I'm on 275, heading toward, if I get with these damn barrels out of my way. That was a laugh. Okay, I'm getting out of these barrels, and I'm going to 471, and I'm going to come down to 27 and turn left.
No, 275 to 471.
Right, 471, and then I'm going to come, oh, shit, this guy wants to play games. Okay, I'm going to 471, and I'm going to turn.
Wow.
And I'm
now is not the time for road rage, Jim. Don't be like, this guy wants to fuck around. Yeah, let's not throw an accident where someone gets horribly injured on top of your charges connected with you being a pedophile.
I'm gonna piss. I hope the hell I don't piss in my car. Shit,
no,
I don't
want to do that.
I also hope you don't piss in your car.
I don't want to do that. No, I don't want to do it. But if I do, I do. I guess I'll just have to take my foot off. It's a joke. Okay. I'm on 471. I see all these wonderful lights and lights and things that they're supposed to be doing to help make us have a wonderful 471.
Follow the light,
okay.
Jim.
Now, when
just
I get
the light.
You'll get there, Jim. Cheyenne will be at the end of the tunnel.
Yes.
27, damn it! I turn left.
Jesus Christ.
Right?
Turn right, I believe. That's where I told
you. Unless your brother's there waiting for me. And if I... maybe your mother wants to see me.
No, my mom's not here waiting for you. It's just me.
Just you?
Okay, you want...
Mr. Identity, do you think that Jim... ever contemplated a threesome with Cheyenne and her mother?
Sorry, can you say that again? One more time?
Yes. Do you, Mr. Identity,
yes,
ever think that Jim contemplated a threesome with Cheyenne and her mother?
Yeah, I mean, of course I think he did, because Jim is just that kind of guy. And he also believes that he could do that. Like, I believe he thinks he could do that.
Well, yeah, I mean...
The same way that he thinks he could talk his way out of that charge in the interrogation room is the same way I think he thinks he could talk himself into bed with, like, you know, anybody.
A mother and her 13-year-old daughter.
Sure, sure.
Yes,
you... yeah, very, very interesting question you posed there. Thank you. Spicing things up.
That's what I'm good for.
It's been fun, actually. Yeah, I'm really having a good time. I don't care. Are you okay with this? Or, I'm having fun. I really am having fun.
What?
Another check-in with Cheyenne. Oh, you having fun? I'm having fun.
Okay. Okay, until I have to get over here. Oh! You get across over three lanes. They didn't tell me that.
You want to go left on 27. You were right. Left on 27.
Give me a shit. I know we're 27. I'm going to get to 27. I'm going to turn left, and then I'm going to turn left, and I'm going to turn right, and I'm going to turn left.
Uh-huh. Okay.
And I'm going to look for 140.
You want to go 471 to the first line?
Okay. I'm on 470. I'm on 471 right now, okay? And I still have to piss.
Well,
you're gonna have to open that bathroom up as quickly as I get there, because if not, I'm gonna piss on your petunias.
Okay. You're on the right foot, right?
Maybe you can help me.
Okay. Are you on 471?
Again, there seems to be a fascination with predators and having these children help them to pee. I don't really understand where that comes
from.
You're
right.
Yeah. Like, he's not the only one. I feel like, and I don't think it's just Lauren either. I think there's another one that says something along those lines. I can't remember which one. But, like, there's definitely some kind of pattern there. Predators asking these little kids to help them pee. Gross, everyone. Gross.
I'm on 471.
Right?
Maybe you can help me.
Okay. Are you on 471?
I'm on 471. I'm looking for the exit for 27, which is right next, which I knew was here. I don't know what the hell happened. I really don't.
You
must have. You knew exactly where I was going. I really did. I really
sure
did.
Sure did.
Unless I have to piss. If I had to piss, I would have started the car.
I'll open the door for you.
I'm more worried about me just making it. Hey, you. Where do you go to school?
I told you where I go to school. I go to school 4 blocks away.
What?
I go to school and four blocks away from my house.
Okay. You know what I do?
What?
I don't teach at all. I work with professors at UC who are doing instructional things with my, I know it's qualified, but I, criminal justice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And as a matter of fact, want to talk about my, okay, I'm turning on to 27 right now. I don't want to get messed up here.
Okay.
I was here before. Okay, there's the exit back onto 471 from Alexandria. I'm driving by Jeff Weiler's big new stuff here. I'm not quite. I'm stopping and stuff. And I still have to pass my car. I should be damn close to you, damn it.
Yeah, you are.
Is your mother there?
My mom is not here. I already told you that.
Are the cops waiting for me?
No. Why would the cops be waiting for you? I'd get in trouble.
Because you're underage. Okay, I'm coming up to a green light. This is right in front of the Jeff Weiler's before the Fisher Homes. It's still green. Should I turn? No, that goes back on the 275.
No.
I'm on 27. There's a flashing light. Sign goes to the right, not to the left. I know yours goes to the left. Oh, shit, I got a piss pad. Okay, I'm passing by this light. There's a lot of history here. There's a real lot of history here. You don't know what I'm talking about, but I was involved in what's called the Beverly Hills Fire.
What business? Are you going by any businesses?
Please?
Are you going by any businesses?
There's a business on the left. It's called Antoine's I'm coming up to the green light. I'm going to turn left there. Is that correct?
I think you want to turn left at the green light.
At the green light? Okay. Thank you. Somebody do.
That's my favorite photo.
Which one?
Okay, there's a crosswalk there, the church.
The one with the band, yeah. Which one is it's Jim in that band picture?
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, it's upper left.
Upper left. Okay, so like the back left?
Mm-hmm. The guy with the goofy smile.
Ah, yes, yes. Let's zoom in a little bit there. There he is. Ah, there's Jim. Wow. He's played in every country club in Cincinnati. Wow.
And again, thanks to Joey's Teacup for providing these tonight.
Yes, yes, around. Thank you. Thank you, Joey.
We talked about this church before. Beyond the church.
Have you? Okay. Wait.
I need to go back on.
Just wait.
Okay, I'll do that.
Did you turn?
This guy's riding on my ass. I'm gonna pull over. And the car wash, you know what I'm talking about? If I went too far, the car wash is right in my way.
Okay, what road are you on?
I'm on 27.
You're on 27. Okay, have you passed that light?
I was on 27. I'm now on 27 and going back up to the church, and I'm going to turn right. Which I think is the turn.
When you got off of 471, which way did you turn? Did you turn right or left?
Left.
Okay. You want to turn...
Okay, here's the church. I'm at the church. Wait a minute. Let me go back to this. I think I got it.
Yeah, Jack Divine Music. I really like that little sheriff's badge he's got on that one picture, because to my knowledge, he's never been a sheriff. So that means he dressed up as a cute little sheriff at one point and posed for a picture.
Doing a little cosplay.
I know, doing a little small town sheriff cosplay.
I think I really have it.
I think you turned the wrong way coming off of 471.
You think so? If I turn left, it was wrong? I'll tell you what. I'm going to go. There's a Antoine's here. I'm going to walk in.
Is that on your right or your left?
Antoine's is on my left. I'll find out. What's the name of the street you have?
You want to get on Camp Road.
On what?
Camp Road, 27. Left on Camp Road, right on Hale, and then left to Bogo.
Camp Road?
Right.
Okay. I'll find out. Hold on a second, and I'll get back with it. Shit, I can't even find
Wait, hold on. Maybe.
There's a little controversy in the chat.
Yeah, I mean, that would make a lot more sense than him dressing up like a little sheriff. And that only kind of looks like him. I wasn't totally convinced that was him either. Yeah, you know what? That might just be a Walker, Texas Ranger. I look ridiculous right now. I don't know my Walker, Texas Ranger characters like I thought I did.
I'll ask him right now.
Okay.
And I'm walking in the store again. Where's Camp Road? Is that right here?
What is it?
Camp
Road? I'm not around.
Okay. Bogle?
No. All I know is it's Alexandria.
You have a bathroom right now.
Huh?
You have a bathroom.
Yeah, it's right there.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. Okay. You know what? Shit. I'm having to... Shit.
There's a genuine. There's a genuine Jim Roush.
I tell you, this is like, okay, ready? Open up the lid. Here we go. I can't believe this thing.
Okay.
That was just a test, you guys, to see if you'd catch it.
Right. Yeah. Good job, everybody. I'm really proud of all of you for knowing your Walker Texas Ranger trivia.
That's right. Yep. You guys passed. Good job.
Good job, everyone. You win this one.
Oh, this is great. He doesn't know what camper road is. He doesn't know anything. Okay, Eric, I've come off 471. Are you listening to me?
I'm listening.
Okay. Yes.
Oh my God.
Well, if I smell like this, because I just pissed on myself. Anyway, 471.
Oh, okay. So if he shows up smelling like piss, it's because he pissed on himself. Hello, Arrowdo. How you doing?
27. 27, turn left. The first road on the left is supposedly Camp Road.
Yep.
And then turn right, and then turn left. And I should be right there.
Right.
I understand where I'm going, okay? I understand exactly where I'm going. I will be there as soon as best I can.
I'll stay on the phone with you in case you have questions.
Well, okay. I'll call you back if I have, but I think
you can't.
I understand where I'm going. It's
you
just
can't call me back, though, Jim.
What?
You can't call me back.
I can't call you back?
No, I told you my mom has my income.
Oh, that's right. Okay. Well, then stay on me. I can't stand my piss on my pants. I don't want to do this. God damn.
So theoretically, we've been listening to Jim urinate this whole time.
I'm trying to hold the
correct
phone.
Correct. Yeah, he
piss at the same time, but more. Okay.
Yes, this is the man. This is a man trying to urinate, for sure.
Great. Excellent.
Just let's revel in that.
I'm reveling.
I'll see what I can work out. Oh God. Shit. Would you, okay, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Okay.
This is not a pleasant mood in my life. Okay, let's see if we can figure this out. 27, right? What's the next for them?
Okay, have you passed the bowling alley?
There's someone in the chat who's really trying to get pissed on by Jim.
Start with C. Start with a C.
Ask him where the bowling alley is.
Where's the bowling alley? No, you need to stop this guy. Come on, help me out, guys. I'm trying to find out where this house is.
Does this person know where they're at around?
Yeah, there? Yeah, they're.
Okay.
This
is Alexandria Pike.
Right, 27, okay. Right.
Highland Avenue, right up, like, right across.
Right here, right here. It goes this way.
Alexandria goes this way. Right up there is Highland Avenue.
Okay, gotcha.
And then, if you go down this way, it'll take you to the levee. If you keep on going straight down this road, it'll take you to Newport on the levee.
Right, gotcha. I don't want to get apart.
You want my address. You're
going to
go, like, downtown
Newport. I don't want to go to Newtown. Downtown Newport.
Here, give him my address.
That direction? Is that the direction I need to go?
You want to go to Highland? You want to go to 140 Vogel Road? Give him that address.
I want to go. What? I'm sorry. I couldn't hear you.
140.
This is the
Vogel
point.
Road.
This is the point in the call where the decoy, like, really doesn't try to mask her, like, displeasure with Jim Roush right now. Like, she's really, like, sounding, like, very annoyed.
Yes, she's, all the niceties are slowly, like, evaporating from her voice.
Right,
she just
right.
wants to get the guy there.
She's been worn down thoroughly by this dumb asshole.
Vogel Road is the one I'm looking for.
Is it off 27?
It's off of what?
27. It's off of Camp. You go 27 to Camp, then you go.
Say it again.
You go to 27, and then you turn on Camp Road. Left on Camp Road, then right on Hale, and then
it's off to the left, right?
It's off to the left, right?
Yes, left on Camp Road.
I'm gonna try it. I'm out of here. This guy is really lost. He's worse than I am.
I doubt it.
Are you mad at me yet?
You. I'm just trying to help you get here.
This is fun.
What
the hell
were you
looking at? This is like a scavenger hunt. Almost. What happens when
glad
I get there?
You
know, fuck me. You think?
What
I'm sorry. I'm just putting you on. I'm just.
Okay. What business were you in?
What business?
Yeah, where did you go in to pee?
Okay, I think I have this all under control. Here's the police. I'm just going to follow them. That's terrible. Okay. I think it's right here. I really do. I think we just missed it. I'm coming down this church. I'm becoming religious. If not, you can tell me. Okay, here's
what
the...
What were you just in, Jim?
Okay,
what did you go to see?
Temple Place. I didn't make a register. We'll go this way. Oh, I'm going behind the church now. And trying to... Okay, you're right. I can hear the anxiety in your voice. Okay,
wait,
I'm going to quit.
What business were you just in?
Evergreen.
Evergreen.
I'm on Evergreen Avenue.
No. Where did you go in to pee?
I'm sorry, where what?
Where did you go in to pee?
I went into that gas station.
What gas station was it?
Right on 27. And I'm going to go back out there because this takes me to the damn back way street. Which don't help me, son of a bitch. I thought I was gonna be able to pull in here and I have all the answers, but you know me, I'm an asshole.
Okay.
Yes, Jim, just follow the trail of police cars all the way to the Sting House.
Okay,
I'm going out to 27. I'm going to this place where this guy doesn't know shit. And I'm coming out here to 27. It's basically 27 and 471, okay? And his place is called... It's right in the corner here. It's kind of...
I know, C&J Div. This call kind of makes me a little bit anxious, too. Because, like, just knowing that he was out there, like, driving drunk, like, doing U-turns, going back and forth up and down the highway. It's just, you know, it's nerve-wracking. Like, he so easily could... This could have been so much worse.
Mr. Identity, do we need a palate cleanser?
I don't know. I hadn't really, like, I don't have any Jim Roush palate cleansers, you know? I there's only so much Roush available to me. I'm saying you guys just have to kind of take it, you know? Lauren is the one that warrants palate cleansers, I think.
Shit, I don't know what name it is. Antoine. I'm stopped.
Oh, and he's fucking back at Antoine's wine, beer, and liquor to, you know, beer tobacco again. Jesus Christ, Jim. Like, we're almost an hour in.
How many times has he passed that church?
Three times he's passed the church. Three times he's passed the beer tobacco, you know. Jesus Christ. Well, people are really, there's some muting and timing out going on in the chat tonight. I know. The poop frog one seems to be in comical fashion. Muting David Gaffney for saying the piss guitar. but you guys are militant this evening.
Copy.
Okay,
Antoine's Wine and Spirits. I'm at the corner of 27, almost to 471. There. How does that help?
I'm looking.
You what?
You are. You're at the corner of 27 and 471?
Yeah. That's basically where I'm at. And this guy's going to rob this place, and I'm going to...
No, don't do that.
What? Yeah, Jim, just give up on the pedophilia scheme. Just rob a gas station. You know?
Did he actually say that? That he was going to rob?
I don't know what he was saying. He's like, oh, maybe I should just rob a place. I don't know. It's a weird thing to say, Jim.
What do you there? Fuck you. One, two, one, two. I think so too. Unless your mother gets home, then it'll be one.
My mom is not gonna be home. Okay, keep going.
Okay, I'm on fucking 27. Okay.
Okay, keep going.
North toward Fort Thomas.
South.
Yeah, totally. I finally have sponsors. Like, today's stream is sponsored by Antoine's Beer Tobacco and Pompilio's. An Italian meal and get your dick sucked, you know? What more could you want out of a chain restaurant?
A cannoli?
South.
A cannoli, I guess, would be nice, too.
It's going south on 27.
I gotcha. This phone is so bad. I'm going south on 27, and you better believe it. Okay. South at 27, and now I'm going past the church. On the left hand, and help me out here, on the left hand side is the church.
Yeah, seriously, amen. Jesus Christ.
Amen. Dude. Amen. I'm praying as I go by. And it is, I don't know what the church is. I'm going down the hill now. I'm going down towards Cincinnati, which I have done.
No!
Ooh, okay, I like that one. This was one of my favorite parts because of how, like, she broke a little bit. That's her breaking character a little bit, I think. Like, Jim, fucking please. Please, Jim. Stop. Antoine's again, Jim.
You're going north.
I'm going, oh God, I'm going north, I guess. Okay, I'm going to go, you want to turn around?
Yes, turn around.
Okay, I'm turning around. Oh, bye-bye, church. Bye-bye, church, bye-bye.
Yeah, bye-bye, church.
You know what, eventually
eventually you will.
And are you going to be exhausted by the time we get there?
Oh, you're like 3 miles away from me.
Okay, I just went by that place I went before, who couldn't help me worse shit.
Keep going on 27.
I'm on 27.
Now look for a road that says camp.
Look for what?
Camp road.
Oh, shit. Cam? C-A-M?
C-A-M-P.
Cam. C-A-M-P.
Yep.
Okay, I just went by Jeff Wilde. I just went by the car dealer. Now I'm going by 471.
Keep going on 27.
I'm on 27. And I'm going toward Fort Thomas.
Toward what?
Fort Thomas. Oh, shit. Am I going the wrong way?
No. Keep going.
Her voice doesn't have that little sing-song quality anymore.
She's kind of, her pace is worn thin. Like, no. Jim!
You know, my almost died up there on top. Now I'm on South 27.
Okay,
I just by Moore's Lump Hardware, which was right by Beverly Hills, which 166 people died, of which I knew 155 of. I'm sorry.
Okay.
That was a moral.
Keep going and you'll see a Lowe's.
Keep going to what?
You see a Lowe's home improvement store.
Okay. Could that be miles? Could it be minutes?
Hang on. Are you going towards Fort Thomas?
I'm going south.
Okay, keep going south.
I'm on junction with 445, and I'm really racing like right now. I just went through a yellow light, and it's called the cops to pick me up. If
was
he does, he's going to get a drunk ass. I'm still on South 25.
Okay, but was Jeff Weiler on your left?
I passed out a while back.
Okay, but was that on your left?
Yes.
Yeah, you're going the right way. Keep going.
Okay, I'm still on 27 South.
Tell me when you see the Lowe's Home Improvement.
And where are you going to be waving to say, come here, come here, come here, come here?
I'll see.
I do. I'm just
somebody's going to be waving for you, Jen.
Okay.
Right, at least there'll be somebody there. Don't worry. You won't be alone.
Are you liking me yet?
Yeah.
I'm talking about the phone call. You know, I can talk like left and right. We can do everything on the internet, left and right. But the truth of the matter is, it's kind of fun. Oh, okay, first this is closed. Okay, now what do we got left?
Okay, keep going. Have you seen?
I'm going until you tell me not to. I run out of gas. One of the two. Okay, what's the time say? Oh, we're still on Highland.
Wouldn't that have just been classic if you ran out of gas?
Oh my god, and that's so much more likely too. Like between the two of him getting there and him running out of gas before he figures it out.
In my universe, yeah. That's the way this happens. That's the way this call ends.
The better timeline.
When you see Lowe's Improvement.
Home Improvement. Okay, gotcha. And if I don't, and we're in Tennessee, will you come and live with me?
Maybe.
What?
Maybe. You're funny. I like you.
Of course
live
you do.
Live with him in Tennessee.
Come live with me. I like you.
You're just like us. I wish everybody was like that. I'm tired of these people have all these agendas. Okay, well, let's see what this is. We're coming into Cornerstone Montessori School. I'm actually coming in, I think into, how am I going to find a Home Depot out here?
I don't know, Lowe's.
Okay. There's Lowe's. I see Lowe's. I got Lowe's.
Okay, yay! You're like 1 mile away from me. All right.
I'm what?
Okay, you're like a mile away from me.
Tell me what to do.
Once you pass Lowe's, on the left-hand side, you will see...
Oh my god, he's so close. He's really circling the drain. And now her, like, instructions are getting even more specific and unchildlike.
Street named Camp.
Named what? Come on, slow down.
Camp Street. C-A-M-P. On the right.
On the right?
Yep.
Camp. C-A-M-P. CM Street.
Lowe's on your left.
I'm looking. Oh, I see it.
Yay!
Okay, Camp.
Okay,
don't worry.
Turn on Camp Street.
Turn right. You got it.
And then you want to go down the hill to Bogue Road.
Go down to what?
So close.
To...
Okay.
Oh.
There's a road here that says... Oh, shit, I can't read it. Vogel. I got Vogel. Now, it says it's right in front of me. Do I turn right or left?
Left.
You got it.
Okay, let me get off the phone, and I'll see you when you get here.
Okay?
Okay. You're never going to the fucking talk to me again, you fucking asshole.
I'm in a stroke.
I'll see you at Toronto.
Vogel Street now. Right?
Right. 140. 140.
Right.
There's a bunch of trucks out here.
All right, I'll talk to you when you get here.
I don't know where I'm going. It stops at one. Okay, go ahead. I see 141. Where's 140?
Isn't it across the street?
It's in the back. Okay, I'll turn it back. I'll just turn right here.
No. Just look for what? 140.
I see 141. It's that house, that white house, right there. Where do I go, behind it or what?
You don't see 140?
I see 141.
Okay.
As I face it. Okay, I'll stop out here. Come and get me.
Okay.
Okay, cool. Bye-bye.
Come and get me.
Famous last words. Yeah, wow.
He had no idea how appropriate that was.
Wow, what a dum-dum. Yeah, that was really irritating, wasn't it? Very, very irritating.
He's kind of an irritating guy.
He is and a he very never irritating shuts up. Guy. That's the thing. He never, he just keeps talking. Because he's like, you know, if I just keep talking then and they can't get a word in, then I can't be wrong or I can't be, you know, I can't be disappointed if I just keep talking.
Or never let me down. Sad thoughts won't come back.
Mm-hmm, exactly. But yeah, do you feel like listening to or watching the interrogation, or at least some of it? I know it is long.
I'm game if you are. Yeah, we can get it started.
Okay, yeah. Hold on. Let me reset this screen here.
Oh, there's that sleepy face.
There's old sleepy face. Start it up.
So you just were out driving?
No, I don't want to admit that.
Okay. Did you come up to see somebody today?
Somebody invited me to come over.
Okay. Mm. Well, who was that?
And he's still pretty confident he's going to be able to talk his way out of this at this point.
He's still really drunk.
He's still also super fucking drunk, so that's, you know, his inhibitions are low, at an all-time low.
Cheyenne something.
How'd you meet Cheyenne?
I was online, came up.
Okay. When you were online, do you do that at home, or do you...
I do it at home.
You do it at home?
Yes.
Is that generally the only place you do it?
Yes.
Okay. What do you have? You have your own personal computer or laptop?
Yes.
Is it
both?
Oh, do you have? You have both?
I actually have two laptops.
You have two laptops?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. It's
my business.
Okay, it's your business. Okay.
What type of business?
I do web pages for University of Cincinnati. I have access to those. I need to have access to them in order to do the business with them. Mm-hmm. With them.
Okay. And you usually use all those computers to chat to people, or chat, or you just use one specific, or?
Usually at home.
Okay, usually at home.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. All
right.
And
if I do chat, I don't do, but that, again, because of the fact of the business that I'm in. Mm-hmm. Chat is a part of what I do, and chat is a part of University of Cincinnati distance learning.
Okay.
And I need to be able to access that. Okay. In order to be able to do the business I do.
Okay.
With them.
Okay. So you met Cheyenne.
I didn't meet Cheyenne. She came after me.
Okay, she came after you? Tell me about that.
I don't know. I don't know exactly how it happened at all. I have no recollection at all what happened for her to make contact with me. I don't know, was I on some line of some sort? I have no idea.
So you were chatting, and she came on to you while you were chatting sometime?
Well, somebody did, whatever, who that sign is.
Okay.
He's
do you know how old Anne was?
She told me she was 13, but and I was very, 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 I don't.
He's like so sure that he's going to like get out of this.
I don't do that.
You don't do that?
I don't want to do that. Okay. I mean, I'm not there.
Not there?
No, not at all. I'd be happy, you know, like give me an 18, 19-year-old, and I'll be happy.
Oh yeah.
13-year-olds, it's gross.
Not your thing.
No.
Okay. And when you were talking to Cheyenne on the chat.
That's very funny. On a bad boy laptop, he's got one of each.
Oh. And a trio.
And a trio, of course, the trio.
What'd you guys talk about?
Well, and up until this afternoon, which was, I don't know what I gave in for, but I thought she was more like an adult. But I was very, very cautious not to be there. I didn't want to be there.
Okay.
I really don't. That's not my thing. I don't like it. I don't want it. Forward as well.
But you might have had a good little curiosity.
No, I don't even. What does Norm? I'm not even curiosity. I don't have any curiosity about it.
And I'm getting a little like video. I think the audio is okay with the video is kind of like laggy and there's a lot of buffering for some reason. But I'll just keep it going, I guess, because I guess you only really need the audio for this. Whatever.
It's too young. It's stupid. And. Now, you can go back and look at all the records of the conversations I've had. Yeah, that's exactly what I said. It's stupid. That's not what I want to be.
You know,
that's not me.
Is that you?
No, not at all.
Do you have any type of webcam or anything like that?
I do have a webcam.
Okay. Do you ever use it for any purposes?
Or? It's available.
Okay.
Use it. I don't know what that means.
Okay.
Use it. I don't know what that means. That line.
So we didn't get into what you guys talked about. What?
Sorry, did you say something?
That when he says use it, I don't know what that means. When they're talking about the webcam, that's always just rubbed me the wrong way.
I know. Always. Yeah, like, yeah, and he, like, he feigns ignorance where it's, you know, convenient for him.
Like, he thinks that he can save himself legally or something. Like, if he doesn't admit he knows how to use a webcam, they can't, you know, like, he's
right,
trying to
be exactly, all exactly.
Clever, and clearly he's not.
But what'd you guys talk about?
I was very, very up until today, which is obviously the reason the results have come. I have been very, very cautious of not talking about anything. I do not want to be involved with a 13-year-old. I do not like it. I don't want it. And I, for some reason, I just get relaxed. And
so, who do you think you were talking to?
Another person.
Another person.
Really, that's perfect. I mean, that's honest with you. I don't know, for whatever worth value that is. I don't know. Miss LA would have made this afternoon to her. I wish I could retract it.
Yeah.
Not because of you guys.
Yeah.
But because of the fact that I just don't. That's not it. That's not me. I don't see it.
Jim, I understand. All right. And I understand you've made a mistake, okay? I've read the chats.
Right. And you can see how...
I see here where you told her that you wanted to fuck around.
Ah, there it is.
And that
I love how casually he brings that up, too. There are a few moments like where the interrogators make me laugh. Yeah, it's like, you know, this part here, you said you wanted to fuck around. And then there's another part where he's like, Jim Rouse says something about, like, the stuff they were talking about being like, you know, what do we talk about? It was, you know, just off-the-wall stuff. And then the detective's like, you know, off-the-wall stuff like a blowjob. And she's just like, yeah, well, like a blowjob.
Gotcha.
We're more provoked at.
Yeah.
I mean, we can go down. I'm not going to go into the details of the thing. Yeah. I understand what you're doing.
Yeah.
And I know what you're doing.
I'm just trying to understand here.
I did not meet with her, number one. Number two, I didn't really want to meet with her.
Okay.
I really, if you go to the bottom lines of things, let's talk about facts that I denied, and I did not want to do that. I really did not want to.
Jim, I know you're under a lot of pressure right now.
I'm not really under pressure at all. I mean, obviously being here is a little bit of pressure, but that's not.
Are you married?
Yes. No. A little bit. No. God, no. You want her? You can have her. I'm sorry.
I got one of my own. I that's enough for me.
Yeah, this is just give her ammunition, that's all.
Well, I'm not trying to give any ammunition for nobody. This is just me, you, and Kate here, okay?
Well, it's not, but...
Well... Okay.
I did not do anything to this, whatever this person is, whoever it is. I did not intentionally meet with... I met with this person because this person, whoever it is, male or female or whatever... enticed me to the point where I wanted to. And I...
Did you... So you guys did talk about sexual acts in your conversations?
I don't remember that.
Okay.
You can go back. Yeah, I don't know. I really don't know. It doesn't really... Yeah. As far as I'm concerned...
He doesn't know.
You know,
it doesn't matter.
You know, I...
Yeah, exactly. Doesn't know. Very selective memory, James.
Maybe at that point he didn't realize that they literally have the chat log right there.
Maybe. Didn't quite know what, like, the extent to which he was fucked.
Yeah.
Jim, I'm just trying to figure out what really happened. Because if we don't talk about it now, and if I just give this to somebody... they're going to think you are a sick, maybe possibly a child predator, and I don't think you're that point, okay?
I'm not.
And you're not. But if we don't talk about it, what else can I tell people saying, you know, Jim made a mistake. This
didn't
happened.
Follow through, number one. Number two. Yeah. Number two, because the fact I didn't follow through is... I'm not so sure that I wasn't turned down when I was picked up.
Yeah.
If you check back on the records, on the results, there have been at least three times where I turned around.
Oh, such a liar!
And I don't do this. I don't. Number one, I don't really want to.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Give me some sex. Okay. And I'll find ways to do the sex, but don't
that's a good one. Give me some sex, and I'll find ways to do the sex. It's really good.
And to say that he turned around three times out of this, you know, moral dilemma.
Makes him seem so...
Lightning just didn't crash upon him.
I know. Well, yeah, why wasn't he smote immediately?
Smote, yes, excellent.
Smote, smitten, first. Yes.
If nobody stopped you tonight, what do you think might have happened?
Nothing.
Nothing?
Absolutely nothing. And I'll be honest with you about that. I nothing. Nothing would have happened. Okay,
Chicanas, is this the place to tell the stories?
Yes. As good a place as any. Jim, we're just trying to be honest with each other.
I went to a swingers club last night.
We're being honest with each other.
Where's that at?
In Dayton.
Up in Dayton, Ohio, Kentucky? Mm-hmm.
Dayton, Ohio. I walked out. And the reason I walked out is because, it's not for me. I'm not selective. I don't want you to think of it as being selective. I'm looking for some satisfaction from somebody. And my own motivation is not to just find somebody who's interested in me. Okay, not young, not old, not fat, not thin, not someone who is interested in.
How about someone who's not 13?
That would be incredible. Yeah, that would probably be the best course of action for old James Roush. But
yes,
you know,
couldn't seem to pull that one off.
Yeah, the heart wants what it wants, you know.
oh goodness.
So I've been divorced or been separated. Or...
We've been divorced for 4 years, almost 5 years.
5 years ago.
I've had relationships with other women. It's not that. It's not a sexual thing at all.
What is it?
It's somebody, and I guess I put this out. Maybe this isn't the right place for doing it, but Cheyenne, whoever Cheyenne is, some George down the hall, talked to me. And when that person talked to me, it was a person. Now, I have other people that I talk to, and for whatever that's worth, and I don't want to bring them into this, but
made you feel good, didn't
it? It kept me away from that loneliness that I had. When I'm sitting in my house by myself, and somebody talks to me.
Nobody to talk to?
Yeah.
You feel that lonely feeling, and, you know.
Whatever, and however that culminates itself.
And she tried and filled that, didn't she? She fulfilled that?
Yeah, but then it turns around because of this crap. Which I understand you mean for doing it. I don't.
So I think there's a need alone.
There's a need for people out there, and that need is fulfilled by and the law enforcement. By the way, I'm in business. I'll tell you that. That's the bottom line. But I am. I work.
That's for definitely not. Department. Definitely not the bottom line, Jim. You're a pedophile. You're non sequitur. Yeah.
Criminal justice. You'd ask for a lawyer. Sorry.
Right. Exactly. Honestly. No. Seriously. Like that is totally. That's pretty much what I was going to say next. Like, if you really worked in criminal justice, you would know to like not be talking for two goddamn hours about trying to talk your way out of it. You know. Like, come on. I'm sure all of this can and was used against him in a court of law, you know?
Or pressured him to take a plea.
Right.
There is a need for people in this society to have a connection with somebody. And I don't care. I don't want where that connection comes from. I think is crucial, and that's where I got fucked up, you know. But don't judge me on that.
I'm not judging you.
I know you're not. I know, but eventually I will be. So yeah, and I know that system, how it works.
But Jim, I can understand that, you know, when you're feeling lonely and you feel like you have, you know, you're just live by yourself.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And you feel that lonely moon, you go home every night. Yeah. You're feeling lonely. You talk to Cheyenne.
Or whoever.
And whoever, you know, you're chatting with Cheyenne here. You feel like you can feel, do you feel like you can feel open to say things?
Right. And I don't, you know. And I think it's unfair of the justice systems to condemn me for talking to someone. If it's underage, I can understand that. And I know that's where you come in. My relationship was created with my relationship to Cheyenne was because of the fact that I closed that out. And I fault you guys with that because of the investigations or how you do that is that person who's making those communications starts to connect with the person. Mm-hmm. And that connection that you make is maybe with the perverted people is one that's really negative. But with the person,
he's almost getting into
the
same type of
it connects.
Speech that he used in the chat log. I don't know how familiar you are with the chat log itself, but like it was all very like stream of consciousness and like these abstract statements about I want to connect, you know, interspersed
right, seemingly
with,
out of nowhere, yeah,
you know, sucking dick, you know, and it's really its own animal in terms of chat logs. It's very, it's not nothing like Lauren's. There's very like traditional, like what we would consider like traditional grooming. It's
sure.
It's almost like he approaches her like an equal.
Well, I don't think he's approaching her as an equal. I think he's trying to like. It's probably just a more subtle way of grooming. It's more like he's trying to treat her normally, so that he kind of has like maybe in his own mind some kind of plausible deniability, where it's like, oh no, I just thought this was like somebody I was talking to online. I was talking to him like a normal person, like I'd be, you know, chatting up an adult person. Not like Lauren, where it's like precious little princess, you're like a little girl, all this stuff.
Right.
Jim doesn't really do that. He's more like subtle in the way he does it. Yeah, he you know, he the treating like an equal is just another way of grooming her, I think.
No, I think you're absolutely right, because a lot of girls want to be seen as older too. So
right, and that's what he's banking
on. To that.
Yeah, for sure.
There's somebody who's talking to you, and I don't know. You do what you have to do. Let's cut the bullshit. Let's go. I'm to the point, you know. I'm lonely. I'm not going to get back to my ex-wife. I wouldn't do that anyway. I have people who don't want to talk to me anymore. I don't. So I have somebody who's Cheyenne who tossed or whoever it is, you know, whoever is Cheyenne. Yeah, it's okay.
Yeah.
Maybe I went over the border. And if I did, I'm paying the price.
So you spend a lot of time chatting?
I don't know what a lot of time is.
I guess it's relative.
It really is.
Yeah.
I mean, probably a couple hours a day.
Yeah.
Maybe three. And most of it's not chatting. Most of it's just trying to find somebody who wants to talk.
Yeah.
And I think that's a major problem too.
What do you generally talk about with Cheyenne or other people? Just whatever
anything,
comes
any,
up.
Anything. Music. The weather, you know, really, you know, it really is. I'm trying to, you know, I'm really being honest about that. I don't think it's going to go any further. I mean, you know, you're this great, wonderful thing. You're going to find out the answers to the world on chatting, but it's a whole world out there, and. I have some real problems with what's going on right here. because I think it's an invasion.
Of course you do.
An invasion of privacy.
Oh, an invasion of privacy. So all Americans are entitled to the privacy to their own statutory rapes. They're allowed to just kind of keep that to themselves, keep things private.
Wasn't that an amendment or something?
Yeah. What's that? Amendment 28, 29?
Something like that.
Yeah, keep that to yourself. Yeah, you can keep that kind of stuff to yourself. Cool.
You have the right to.
Jim knows his rights.
Not in terms of the younger age. I think that somebody else should have stopped that before I got to it.
Well, I'm not a chatter.
Okay.
So if you could educate me a little bit on,
okay.
where would you go to find somebody to talk
to? In the case of the Cheyenne thing, that was done through Yahoo Messenger, who has, if you're 18, you're not allowed here. If you are in the sessions, adult,
yeah.
Adult, Kentucky. And in that regard, that's where I really come off with I think it's not fair for you to come at me.
Of course.
Because
she was in an adult chat room, even though she made it clear that she was 13, and you acknowledged she was 13 and said, "Is it okay if I still come over and fuck you, Cheyenne, even though you're 13?"
He reveled.
Of course, yeah. Right. But, you know, now it's not fair for them to come at him because she was in an adult chat room, you know? If she's in an adult chat room, she just has to be treated like an adult. That's the rules, right?
Except for the fact that
Jim wishes that was.
Yeah.
Up front, because of the way you guys do the way you do things, you make sure that you say it's 13, 14, whatever. But it shouldn't be there in the first place. If it's going to be something that legally binds Yahoo or Goggle or whoever it happens to be to
Goggle.
Be an adult place to go.
One of my favorite search engines.
I love Goggle.
Then, if I go there, and you even say that you're 13, why are you there in the first place? How did you get through that first level? And I really have a problem with it. You guys have heard this over and over and over.
I'm really interested in knowing how this chat thing works and how you met Cheyenne.
I don't have an idea. To go back to that. I don't know what initiated the first conversation with Cheyenne. I don't remember. It could have been 3 weeks ago. It could have been a week ago. I have no idea. But I know that maybe I went through and I looked and I went down my list of people who were adult cams. And I said, "Hey, you interested in talking?" Boom, webcam available. And she came, the name came up.
So you could tell that they had a webcam?
Yes, you can tell that.
Okay. So that's something that you look for
when you talk to people? No. I don't look for it. No, I look for somebody to talk to. You know, and...
But if they have a webcam, even better.
It doesn't really matter. It really doesn't matter.
Even better.
It means that
clearly.
Why do you keep bringing it up, Jim?
Right. Why do you keep wanting webcams to be available if you don't want to view them, Jim?
They're probably prostituting. They're putting their stuff out in the camp. Most likely, it means it doesn't mean a damn thing at all.
So what happens after that?
I put up a message out and they respond. And her. And Cheyenne responds.
What happens after that? I'm not tech savvy.
So Cheyenne responds. She says, "Hi, how are you?" "Hi. Yeah, what you doing?" And it goes from there. And then, you know, if they're in the legal system and they're taking care of their little niches that they need to take care of, say, "Well, hey, I'm all on 13. "Oh, that's okay. Still want to talk to you. What's going on? How's school today?" That sounds so trite. And it does. I mean, in terms of me, I'm a teacher. I've been a teacher. Done it. How was your school today?
I don't know why these people think that bringing up the fact that they are teachers, that they successfully taught school, like why that is something that they bring up to like show that they're innocent. Like they think that's probative of their innocence in some way. Like
yes, it's not worse.
Right. It makes it so much worse. I don't know where they get this. You know, it's incredibly misguided. Like they think like, oh, you know, I've been around kids for years. How could I be a pedophile if I've been around kids for years? I would say you placed yourself around kids for years because you're a pedophile, Jim. How about that? Jim.
Is not, well, let me get in and fuck you. That's not it. It's understanding that person. And I guess that's what the...
Because they have social needs too, just like you. They have like social needs.
Here, okay, and in what is presented to me from Cheyenne, or whoever it is, stupid, except me as one, is here's this girl, supposedly girl, who supposedly is going through a divorce, whose parents are separated, not as an opportunity for me as a predator to go after them.
I mean, except that's exactly what it was, right? Like, what else was that? All of these guys, like, prey on... And I mean, obviously, the decoy is probably, like, that part of their narratives is probably, you know, emotional trauma or emotional damage because they know that these men will gravitate towards that because that's what, you know, it's pretty textbook.
But as a person... To try and answer questions,
you're helping them.
Except for, like I said this afternoon, and I only went overboard because of the fact that I personally was frustrated. But that's the internet.
So, do you see your role as helping them through their life as well as them helping you?
I'm always doing that. That's the person I am.
Sounds like you've done it for many years. I mean, you've helped people, you know.
30, 40 years.
Yeah.
And not on the internet, but yeah.
Well, I'm not saying in your lifetime, you've helped many, many people.
To my colleague, it's next door to me. I'm helping her do what she needs to do. I'm not a bad person. Really not.
So cringy.
And I didn't hurt her.
My God, yeah, seriously. You know, it's that's what good people tend to say. I'm not a bad person. I'm not a bad person. Notoriously, that's what they say.
It's like he's almost trying to convince himself.
Exactly. That's exactly what it is. He's. I think it's starting to sink in the gravity of his situation, and he's trying to almost, you know, talk himself down, convince himself that he's not, like, you know, a pedophile, which, you know, clearly he is.
Mm-hmm. Cheyenne was, which was, and I knew it. I don't know. Maybe in the back of my mind, I think I'm.
Oh, and what's going on, Cornville Consigliere, New Wave Ghost, Riffy Pete, Kingpin, Aaron Drake. Good to see you all this evening. New Wave Ghost. I say New Wave Ghost. I don't know. Hello, New Wave Ghost.
Happy Lauren to everyone.
Oh, happy Lawrence, one and all.
This is bad. I knew this was bad. And in the back of my mind,
I knew what was bad.
It was all a setup.
Oh, talking with her was a setup?
Yeah, from the beginning. and in that frame, I was hoping that it wasn't. But in the good nature that I am, I really wanted to help. I
Oh, don't they always just want to help?
They do.
Don't they always just want to be a father figure to these kids? So noble. It's crazy how NBC, you know, would manage to vilify these people with such noble, you know, good Samaritan-like intentions.
How are you going to help her tonight?
I don't know. Tonight?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, tonight.
Talk with her.
Oh, I think we know, Jim, how you are going to help her.
Yes. Coming to fuck you, Cheyenne.
Talk with her about this divorce thing that her parents were going through. I mean, really, that was my gist.
Do you think it could have been more?
No. Got it. Okay. Let me go back to what was talking last week. I went to, like I said, a swingers club last night.
That's all these guys' problems. Sorry, sip of water. Their problems is that their hearts are too big.
Oh, is that his problem?
Yeah, that's Jim's problem. His heart is too big. I mean, maybe, you know, literally, he might have an enlarged heart, but that's the only problem he has. Not in the way you're saying.
I signed David. I walked out. Three women there. That's not what I mean. I mean, sexual.
But in your chat, you ask if she would have sex.
Well, only because I was trying to get that corner into to her to let loose and, you know. And I don't know. Maybe in the wrong. Maybe in the bad sense of things. Maybe that was it. But I don't think it was. I wouldn't have followed through with it.
Think it was more trying to get a connection with her.
Yeah. I really do. I think she just doesn't know where she's going. She doesn't know where she's going.
She's trying to figure life out, and you're trying to help her figure that life out.
At least in my sense of
it. In your mind.
So he came to Cheyenne in his capacity as a life coach. Yeah, Jack Devine, to let loose. Jim really felt comfortable enough to let loose. You know, talking about off the wall, like blowjobs.
In your mind,
he secretly hoped she would change her name from Sad Cheyenne to like Happy Cheyenne. Just
yeah, that's what he wanted. He wanted her to be up. How are you so up?
I would have. The last thing I wanted to do was come over here to Campbell County and meet a 13-year-old. Give me a break.
Give me a break.
Last night I could have had two women. Why would I want to do? Why would I want to do that?
You dog, Jim Roush.
Disappoint two women.
I know, he disappointed two women by walking right back out again. I'm like, Jim, I can almost hear the women's voices as the door opens and shuts behind him. Jim, please don't go. Jim, please, we just want, we need that dick, Jim Roush. Get back in here.
But tonight you were just trying to help somebody.
I really feel I was trying to do that. And I turned her down twice. If you read those damn emails, I turned her down twice.
Did he? He did not turn her down twice. He checked in with her.
In the chat log, he did. He said something like, "This is too dangerous."
Uh-huh.
And then, like, the next day, he just starts up the conversation. Or something. They're very thin.
He's just being coy. He's being a little coy and then jumps right back into, like, you want to suck dick? You want to fuck me? Yeah, of course.
And I think there's a couple other predators who like brought, you know, like they brought like a letter. You know, it's that.
Oh, yes, the alibi letter.
the alibi letter. Yeah, that's his little. He's planting alibis.
Right. My intentions were purely to mentor this child.
Like, I struggled over this decision. I truly just wanted what's best for Sad Cheyenne.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure. I'm sure.
I'm scared. I don't want to do it. It's too much for me to do.
Yeah.
And I really felt that way, but I was trying to... She was so searching. Now, again, it's that... And this is the part that bothers me, isn't it? That provoking... To get me to do something. Without that provoking, she'd have backed off. If it had been backed off, I would not even thought about it.
Yeah, but she must have really needed you for you.
No,
to,
not
for
she.
Her
whoever
to...
it is. Let's make clear.
Right, but what you thought that she needed.
I love when he does that too. Where he's just I don't know, it's not a real girl.
There's very few of the predators during the interrogation that make that distinction.
Really? I hadn't really noticed that. Is that the case? Yeah, maybe they do. Like, a lot of them are like, oh yeah, like Bailey or B or whatever their names are.
I mean, maybe at the once in the beginning, but like once they start getting into the conversation, it's just that little kid again, and he kind of sticks to his guns and keeps going back to the fact that it was a decoy, or he doesn't know who it was.
Right, exactly.
You know, he's in criminal justice. So.
Exactly.
So you just...
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. And you know what? I go back to that in relationship to the police department, the criminal justice. You gotta watch out how far you take that. Because there are people who do care about other people. And I'm...
You can't be rounding up every single pedophile. Some of them really care about these kids, you guys.
It's people caring about other people.
It's people caring about people. Yes, thank you.
You can write off this thing. You can take me to court and all that.
They were.
I wasn't going to hurt that kid.
And I don't think you were.
I wasn't.
Jim, I honestly think you were not going to hurt Cheyenne or whoever you thought you were going to meet tonight. Jim, I know you're not going to hurt her. Right?
No, I wasn't.
I don't think you had any...
I have more intention of hurting myself than I do hurting her.
But you needed to fill a void.
It's not a void. I don't want to make it a void. I got people I talk to some places. Okay,
about a need.
I have a need to help people. Yeah. Maybe that's closer to it than filling a void. Because I do have people who have problems, and I have no problems, but yeah.
Relationships are hard, and it sounds like that the connection that you were making with her, she was innocent, you were innocent, you were just trying to help her, and it just got out of hand.
It got out of hand. I agree with you.
Yeah, and it's much easier to talk to a younger person because they're more open and understanding.
But see, and again, this is the lesson I think that you need to learn. You're playing a role, and whoever's doing it is playing the role of something that they're not. And when they play that role, they've got all this stuff behind them, all this garbage, but not garbage. It's not really garbage. It's really experience. Okay, they've got that behind them, and they're manipulating it all the way through.
Exactly, New Wave Ghost. It's all cyber. Who does Jim even apologize to? Shove that camera down your throat.
And with a person or a good, successful... officer, who is doing this, a good officer can remove that a little bit, so they can be innocent to bring it in. But the return on that, which is the problem,
what is he talking
is the person
about
from
right
the outside
now?
Who comes in.
Literally, I have no fucking idea. I was kind of getting concerned that maybe I missed something, but he might just be like, he's just trying to talk his, like, he's trying to stall until he can think of something, like, good to say to try to get him out of that room. I think.
Goodness.
Yeah. Yeah.
They don't see it as that person who has all that control. And therefore, relax, give up levels of intensity that they might not have if they were talking to an adult. And therefore, because of relaxing that intensity,
relaxing
maybe
the intensity?
Some things out that need to get out.
Yeah, you gotta relax the intensity, you know?
I'm getting that tattooed on my back.
Yeah, don't relax the intensity. Don't overwhelm these kids. Gee, yeah, Jim knows how to finesse it, you know?
Is he trying to give them advice on how to be better decoys?
I think maybe he's trying to give them advice on how to be better decoys. And I guess he's also kind of like low-key, like he's kind of like flexing how good he is at grooming kids a little bit.
Like, this is how you can be more effective.
Like, guys, you know, this is how I do it. So this is how you could do better at countering it.
Once I relax the intensity.
Right, yeah, you and George down the hall. Exactly, Joey.
But also, go over.
And just like a side note, if anyone knows a better way to, like, get Streamlabs to stream like a window in Chrome without like so much lag, that would be great. Not that the audio is fine, I just like want to know for future reference. If anyone knows how to do that, let me know. I'm just using window capture in Streamlabs and super laggy.
And expect that.
And hello, Callie lady. Really enjoyed you with Babsby. Good to see you here.
Amazing, wasn't she?
Very much, yeah, very, very much so. These streams.
And she was pretty good too, I must say.
Oh yes, absolutely. Wait, what was that?
Oh, just that Shin's Koala did a great job.
Oh, Shin's, yes, Shin's was very good. Yeah, I also really, yeah, I enjoyed Shin's also.
Who's on the other side, who is intelligent enough and has the experience enough to really understand what's going on there, makes a critical judgment instead of an emotional judgment on what's happened to a person like me. I don't know if that makes sense, but do what you have to do.
No, Jim, it makes zero sense.
I mean, I really do. It's either going to crush my life or we're going to go.
I think by getting it off your shoulders and talking about it, I think at least you're making a step somewhere. I mean,
I'm not trying to get some damn 13-year-old in my bed. That's not it. If I want to get somebody in my bed, I go to the swingers club. I go to the people I date, which there are three or four that I normally date. And I can do that. I'm not a predator. I'm not that in that ballgame. I don't like even young women. There's a little problem with that. I'm sorry. It's like young.
What was that?
Do you believe that he really has three separate women that he can call on whenever he wants?
I'll bet the nature of those relationships are a lot different than he thinks they are. I'll bet if he were to call them up for real, he would not get the reaction from the three of them that he thinks he will.
I think you are exactly.
Yeah,
right.
I'm gonna guess if we talk to those women, they're gonna be like, Jim who? A few, you know, at least one of them.
young guy, little guys. Put them over there.
That's not your thing.
Okay, it really is something.
That's not your thing.
But beyond my not my thing, it's I don't. There are people out there who do, and that's not me. I'm really serious.
You know, Jim, if I thought that was you, I wouldn't waste my time here with you. Because if I felt that way, I'd say, you know what? Jim's like that. Throw you away. And out the door I go.
Okay, let me give you another indication. I taught music for 31 years. Mm. I have never been arrested in that 31 years for any kind of child molestation or anything.
Oh, good job not getting caught for this long. Clearly, that means you've done something in the past.
It's different.
Right. You know, that sounds an awful lot like you did something and you're just proud of having gotten away with it. Yeah. Like, I successfully taught music as a pedophile for 31 years. Like, that's something you overcame. Right, never got caught being a pedophile around all those kids. Yay me. Good job, Jim.
In the 31 years, I've seen many, many kids go through my system. And through the systems that I work. It's the wrong ball game. It's not me.
The wrong ball game.
So when you were online chatting, and you felt that you felt like you were talking to somebody who possibly did understand and probably had some experiences, you felt like you could let go, right?
That's a really good point, Poop Frog. I've also heard that. If you've never been arrested before, you cannot get arrested. Like, if you get arrested and don't have a record, they have to let you go. people who don't have records can't commit crimes.
You know, it's funny.
Really?
Yes, that's a very little known fact about the criminal justice system.
And to put it in perspective, over the last couple weeks, which China's been going, I did not feel that way until tonight. And I don't know what made that difference. I have no idea what made that difference, but I felt like maybe it's a movement on the part of the people whoever did it. To kind of motivate me to go that direction. I really was very, very cautious of not letting any information out, not even my emotions until tonight.
Tonight you felt, you know, that you could.
Yes, Joey points out another gaping loophole in the legal system. If you didn't mean to do a crime, you cannot have committed that crime or be accused of that crime.
No, I have heard. Wow.
Yeah, something to keep in mind.
I guess I was looking free. I was tired of playing games and doing things and just backed off and just. Okay, you want to talk? You want to get together? Here's my phone number. Give me a call. I'll do it. I mean, really, it's
and you let your guard down.
I let my guard down.
Is that what that was? I'm coming to fuck you, Cheyenne. Is that you letting your guard down?
He's, you know, being vulnerable.
Of course. It's vulnerability.
I can't even
Only
say
because
it.
Because of the fact that I've had my guard up for weeks, and through that guard that I had, I thought maybe she needs some help. Maybe she needed to talk to someone. Maybe she was moving in a direction that I could help her in some way. Really, that's the honest answer.
And what did you want to talk to her about? Regards to
I wanted to open up those channels. I don't know where she was in that regard. I wanted to open it up so she could talk to me. And she in the past she was guarded too.
And she. You talked about a lot of things. You said you talked about, you know, different things. How is it you guys talk about? I know you said you let your guard down and you fell in love with her. How many times did you guys talk about sexual things?
Nothing until tonight. That I'm aware of. I don't remember anything, the connotation of the thing. If it was like really off the wall.
Off the wall?
Yeah, it wasn't like as straightforward as it was.
So what do you consider straight, kind of off the wall? Just something that you remember to talk about?
I don't remember specifically.
Used off the wall things, maybe about giving a blowjob or anything like that, or
talking about what kind of relationship.
There it is.
You guys.
Oh my god.
Used off the wall things, maybe about giving a blowjob or anything like that,
or talking about.
Oh my fucking god. I love that. He's just so. He gives it to him so subtly.
Like
something off the wall, like something off the wall, like giving a blowjob, something like that. I don't know. Off the wall, like blowjobs.
Just off the wall things, maybe about giving a blowjob or anything like that, or
talking about what kind of relationship do you have? She have with her boyfriend? And,
did you guys go deeper than that?
He ever touch you? About that.
Those cocktail party conversation starters. Got a boyfriend. Did he touch you?
That's about the bottom.
I think those are going to be our next year's college entrance exam.
What was that?
I think they're going to be on next year's college entrance
yes. exam. I mean, if Jim has anything to do with the writing of those exams, then almost certainly. Mr. Distance Learning over here.
Deeper than that? I mean, any...
Not until tonight. No. I'm not sure she really went that far with me as much as I went for her. Which is my problem.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
What did you guys talk about tonight that just kind of seemed like everything?
I don't know what it was about tonight. I don't know what provoked that. Maybe it's just a commonality or just a talking over a period of time, which is probably about a lot of it.
Kind of culminated over a couple
no,
of weeks.
No, it wasn't a culmination. It was more of a Just a relaxed nature between two people. It wasn't a culmination of things. It was more of a relaxed nature of. Understand each other?
All that vulnerability he mentioned.
You felt like you were on the same page.
That we could talk about something.
And you were open. You guys were open.
I agree with that. I think for some reason it became more open tonight than ever before.
I wonder why. Like, she didn't open it up. You know, it was you being a fucking creep. Exclusively.
Maybe Mercury was in retrograde.
Oh, of course. We always forget about this about celestial intervention and with these sorts of things.
That's why I'm around.
Yeah. Thank you.
And then obviously exploded. But again, I jump on you guys for that. I jump on you for that. Because
I jump on you for that. Him acting like he has the moral high ground at any point during this conversation is a little infuriating. It does make me a little mad at him.
It doesn't bode well.
No, and no, David Kendrick, you didn't really miss anything. It's just Jim Roush being a fucking pedophile, the usual.
Yeah.
that what I needed, whether it was Cheyenne or Joe Blow, I needed somebody to talk
Cheyenne
to.
Or Joe Blow.
And
or Joe Blow, right. Or George down the hall.
And instead of somebody to talk to, I ended up with investigations. Well, I understand. I don't criticize you for it. Don't understand. Don't misunderstand.
I understand.
It's a real social, and it's a real social problem. I don't know how often do you do this every night?
No. This is Jim. You know, like I said before, we're just trying to get at what happened tonight and what's been happening. And, you know, I understand that...
He's starting to kind of resign himself to the fact that he's not going to be leaving that room. You can just kind of see his, like, his face, I feel like, was a little bit, you know, a little bit brighter. He had a little bit more hope in his eyes before, like, you know, maybe like 45 minutes ago. And now he's starting to sink in a little more.
I mean, can you imagine the adrenaline is starting to fade, you know, he's probably getting tired.
I know, yeah. Oh, right, and he's also coming down from... Oh, sorry, go ahead.
Oh, he probably has to pee again.
Right, he has to pee again, and he's also coming down from being drunk, which is also a very, you know, no pun intended, sobering experience. Yeah.
He's probably craving, like, chicken and waffles.
Right, so goddammit. Just wants to go to Waffle House. Hello, Jet Set Girl. Hello, Witchity Man. Hello, Bison Burger.
Hello, David and Kendrick.
Yes, David Kendrick. Hello, David Kendrick. And then, you know what? Another hello to Poop Frog, just because he's there.
You've had a rough time. Mm-hmm. You needed to talk to somebody.
Yes.
You could have... Went out with two women or three women the other night.
15. I mean, two nights.
Okay. Talked to Cheyenne, made you feel good. Kind of
It solved a problem. But it didn't solve a problem in terms of I didn't do anything except for talk.
Yeah. And when you
Shin's koala,
and then tonight was just culmination of
what did he?
You know, you felt like. You
what
know,
did he say?
Shin's koala says he probably has to fart big time.
Oh, for fucking sure. He's got all those hops just fermenting in that you know furnace of a gut.
For now.
Yeah.
Hey, maybe.
Yes, Eddie Schmetti, the beloved Poop Frog.
Maybe I need to see her. Maybe she can actually. I can open up to her.
And that's really essentially it. Would it come to in some sexual thing? I'm not going to say it wouldn't, but I'm on the other side of me, which it wouldn't have. It wouldn't have. I can't believe your phone rang.
Oh my god!
It would not have.
He's
been,
so
would,
indignant.
Oh yeah, yeah, Jim. How rude! You know what I think's a little rude, Jim? Trying to fuck a child. That's pretty rude.
Never reached that point because of the person I am, mm-hmm. And because I would never take an advantage of her. If you go back on those and you'll see it, how many times I asked her, are you sure you want to do this? Are you sure?
That was for your benefit, not hers, Jim.
I didn't want to hurt her.
Precisely.
I didn't want to... She was young, supposedly. She was young, and I did not want to do that. I really... This young thing...
I don't think you... Jim, you did not... I know you didn't want to hurt her.
No.
And you went there tonight to see her.
You know what? I bet he doesn't realize that the calls were recorded at this moment.
Oh, for sure. And of course, he's like, you know, he might not really know that they had like the chat log right there. Or maybe he does at that point. Or no, they talked about the chat log already. Like off the wall stuff, like blowjob. Yeah, that's in the chat log.
They haven't referenced anything in the calls.
Right, right. So that's possible. Oh boy, because that's a really embarrassing one. Like driving like audibly drunk, talking to a little kid. Like, you sure you want me to come fuck you, even though you're 13? Like, okay. Gross.
No. And things could have, you know, but you would, I don't think if anything would have happened, now I'm talking anything, you would have never hurt her. I know.
No, I wouldn't.
You wouldn't.
That's not me.
That's not you. You know, you were there for her. You were going to try to be there for her. And you came here for that reason, to be there for her.
Let's be realistic about that too. Yeah. I came here to be for her, possibly sexually too.
Yeah.
What? And
but
that is fucking insane.
I don't know if I could ever have done that.
Jim, that is fucking crazy to say that to them.
Do you think he's forgotten where he is?
he must have forgotten. I don't know what he was trying to prove by saying that. I don't know what he thought he was going to get out of saying that to them. Like, I wanted to be there for her, possibly sexually, too. Oh, my fucking God. Exactly, Eddie. Case closed. Case closed. Everyone, like, it's possibly sexually, too. Are you drunk? Yes, you are. There's the answer. You're drunk.
I don't think I could ever. I mean, I'm serious. I told you this, went to the swingers club. So I've been dating. I have gone there twice, and I've walked away because, no, that's not what I want. I want to go to some place and meet somebody who really, really needs what I am, not my dick, you know?
He wants you for you, wants Jim.
Yeah, and I'll do a hell of a lot for that. We can go into personal details on that, but there are people in my life who would do anything for me to just give up everything I have and just go with them.
What?
But I won't do it. And there are other people on the inside who need every bit of me, and I can't give them that because I've got this other person.
This all sounds like
really
wishful thinking to me.
Doesn't.
I know. Again, this sound. I'll bet if we ask these women what the nature of their relationship with Jim Roush was, at least one of them would respond with Jim who. 100%. Someone would say. I don't know if I like, Jim, yeah, I know him. That's how they would respond. And it's probably the one that you think would, like, want you to move in. Oh, my God. The king of wishful thinking over here.
Yes.
Who won't say the thing?
Oh, there he goes. Now he's starting to cry. Oh, I like that pause. That pause face.
Oh.
I don't know. Oh, he's so sad, that sad little boy. Oh, he's just... My charge bothers me so fucking much. That's what that face says to me. Old crocodile tears Roush over here.
Poor puppy dog.
Poor little puppy dog Roush.
Sounds like there's a lot of relationship issues going on for you right now.
Oh, absolutely. I have no question about it. I can be specific about it. You want specifics or you want to talk about legalities? I have a girlfriend who won't get me.
Right. Jim, are you crying? Jim, why are you crying? Why are you crying, Jim? It's going to be all right, Jim. It's going to get better.
Get married, who doesn't want to see me except for on the weekends when she wants to get fucked.
Okay. Oh,
I have another one.
Hate that.
Who would love for me to just move in with her.
That's the woman who would say Jim who, if you asked her, who wants me to move in with her. That's the lady who'd be like, I'm sorry, I don't really know who you're talking about.
I can't move in with her because she's not going anywhere. She's not.
I want this one to come around and shoot it out.
Yeah, Cali lady, swingers don't cry. the tears of a swinger. That's what this stream should be called. Tears of a swinger.
Well, so what I do, juggle phone calls on those two. Then we add in the other emotions of, you know, okay, so I can't satisfy any one or two. I know you. I can see you're gone on this. You have no clue what I'm talking about. But this is all going on.
But these are your feelings.
Yeah.
These are your feelings.
Well, no, they're beyond my feelings. They're people who affect my feelings. And they're people who I can get down on my knees and say, stop this shit.
Stop this shit.
And they did. So eventually I'll die and everybody else will go on.
Jim's still alive, right? That's confirmed.
Yeah, there were some recent calls to him. Not by anyone in the community, by this other guy who has a channel.
Oh, I think I saw that, like an interview with Jim Roush. I would, yeah, that's interesting. Okay, still alive. Well, I guess he still has time to move in with this woman he thinks is just waiting for him to give her a call.
Yep.
I wonder if he ever reached out.
And tonight,
this is, as I said, I don't care. I don't want to be involved in a whole bunch of legal shit. I've been there before.
Oh, you're going to be involved in a lot of legal shit, Jim.
Yeah, I don't really think you know the extent to which you're going to be involved in legal shit.
I know what it's like. I know what this shit is like. And,
but you wouldn't be there for her tonight.
I wanted to help somebody out. I wanted somebody. Her mother was not.
What's going on? So fun.
Around. Her father was not around, and she didn't know what to do.
And she had emotional feelings, mm-hmm. sexual feelings.
Mm-hmm.
She had a multitude of feelings.
Right. And I could answer some of those by my dialogue, I would say. And make that for her.
You know, but right now, we're talking about it, and that's the main point. I mean, you could come in there and say that, you know.
I still feel sabotaged.
I'm not trying to sabotage you.
But I feel sabotaged. Yeah. Because of the fact that I'm
poor Jim, being sabotaged in his attempts to have sex with a child. Boo-hoo.
Boo-hoo.
Boo-fucking-hoo, Jim.
I'm not out there fucking the 13-year-olds and getting them drunk and taking them up to hotels, as we obviously know from the news today. I'm not doing that. And I don't have a desire to do that.
But you felt a connection tonight.
She needed you,
and you.
And I needed her in some sense. And I needed to be able to
let yourself go.
No. I needed to
let yourself go.
There's a needy thing.
To help her.
I needed to fulfill a need of somebody. And he I've always to done it all my life. I can go back to history with my school. And it's always that, trying to find some way to help some kids. And I really felt that need. And that's not bullshit, that's just the way I feel.
That's bullshit? I mean, if that's the way you feel, I mean, I don't think that's bullshit.
Well, I know, but on the outside of it, and people look at it, they don't see it.
But you have feelings. I mean, you'd be inhuman if you didn't have feelings. And tonight was about feelings. Tonight was about feelings, and tonight was about you trying to help someone who you thought you needed.
Help them is the key word there.
Yeah. And you wanted to share.
I wanted to be able after the discussion of the we talked about, if it's sexual or whatever it happens to be, I wanted to share that this is how I would see it. What do you need?
Where do we go from there? What how does my role change with you? Enough labor. Do what you have to do.
Of course. Now it's time to cut the bullshit, right?
Mm-hmm.
What, 50 minutes into the conversation? He sits there for another, like, fucking hour and a half. Psycho. Call Mr. Criminal Justice, ask for a lawyer, now.
You know, Jim, you've said several times that, you know, you feel sabotaged.
Mm-hmm.
We're not here to make life harder for you. I mean, you're in the situation that you're in, and right now we have an opportunity to talk through things and maybe get you in a better situation so that you don't feel sabotaged.
Okay, in that relationship, in that perspective, how do I deal? I'm going to be online, unless you guys chop off my arms, take the job away.
Well, they might not chop off your arms, but can't imagine you'll stay at the University of Cincinnati after this one, Jim.
And deal with that when I see somebody who does have a need.
I'm actually pretty taken aback by how much that Muppet looks like Jim.
It's pretty uncanny, actually.
It is, yeah.
I must admit, I've been kind of staring at it.
I know, me too.
I don't mean searching out. I'm not talking. I'm somebody. I am. That's.
And yes, exactly, Shin. Like, he's clearly sobering up now, and it's like starting to sink in exactly what's going on, and he's starting to get a little panicked. Not like crazy panic, but like just like you see it in his face a little bit. He's starting to look a little worried.
I never.
Exactly, Hetero Dan. I'm gonna lose everything I have, Mr. Garrett.
Have gone to somebody on the internet who hasn't responded to me. However that plays a perspective in how you deal with the job that you do. For me, once they respond to me, then I have, not an obligation, do I need to answer them, or do I shut it off? And that is really hard for me.
Yeah.
That is really hard. When somebody said, hi.
Wait a minute. After is I said Jim hi to saying them, that he has a hard time saying no?
I think Jim might be saying this is all due to the fact that he's unable to say no. You know, maybe did his siblings one too many favors, got nothing in return.
He can't not answer an IM from a stranger.
I know, it's starting to sound a little familiar, isn't it?
Man, there might be something to that then.
Yeah, there might be some food involved that we don't know about. some exchange that should have been made that wasn't made. That Jim's a little bitter about may have driven him to the to his current predicament. It might have driven him to try to have sex with a child. What are the chances?
That his ex-wife used to make, like, mac and cheese.
I know. Oh, man. I mean, the chances are pretty high, I think.
I think, yeah.
Yeah.
Break a new ground.
I mean, just that simple. Just that simple. If I don't respond to them, it says...
Oh, hey there, Molly. How are you doing tonight?
Hey.
And hey, Clinton.
He doesn't care. It's like the 37,000 other people that don't care. You know? And I have a real problem with that, because if somebody responds to me, I always respond to them.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm sorry. What do we do?
If you could talk more about the information that you exchanged with Cheyenne as far as pictures or chat.
I did have my webcam, and my webcam has been both been both visual as well.
We just need a little bit more evidence before we can charge you properly.
Could you just maybe keep talking for maybe like 45 more minutes? Just to make sure we got our case?
Yeah, no problem.
As long as you fill my tires with air.
Genitalia.
Shut the fuck up. Genitalia. Yeah, getting clinical will make it a lot better for you. That really softens the blow, genitalia.
Visuals, obviously seeing me facially.
Seeing you genitalia. Facially, really?
Genitalia.
How many times would you say?
I would say maybe one or two times that she has accepted to see me.
And that was on Yahoo.
And it was her. I never forced it on her. She always asked to have it.
This Jim Rausch interrogation is kind of a slow burn, but once he starts talking about genitalia, it really heats up, in my opinion.
I am not super familiar with Yahoo chat rooms. Isn't it anytime they started a cam session, you had to accept it to get the image?
I believe, the way he's explaining it. What was that?
It's not really her giving consent, like approving or anything.
She's just clicking
the button to get the image.
Exactly.
It's not always been genitalia, but it.
Okay, stop saying genitalia. But that's only
because of the fact that that's the way I was at that point. Okay. Cheyenne is going to be on, so let's put it on my dick. No, it was never that. It was there. I just clicked on webcams available. She accepted it. Or not accepted in most cases, and she didn't always accept it.
Mm-hmm. Well, was this in response to the conversation you were having?
There was usually no conversation in relationship to that. No conversation, nothing. Is this an adult cam? No, even that. This cam is available.
When you sent that,
but that's again. But in relationship to other people other than Cheyenne, that was common practice.
What did you hope when?
If somebody wanted to look at it, they could look at it, decline, and look at it, stop, go on, do their own. That was my.
Diabetes.
That was my. That was what I expected them to do. If they didn't want to see it, they didn't do it. If they did see it and didn't look at it, they could click on.
Diabetes. So you said that that's something that's. If she wanted to view it, she could view it. If she didn't, she didn't want to view it.
Exactly. And I would have done that with. I would have done that beyond Cheyenne. But way. All of any other people that I had any contact with. I mean, when you go through hundreds and hundreds and hundreds, and you get a response, and you put on my webcam is available. That's it, and then you get that choice.
So,
his webcam was incredibly available.
There were webcam shots of
hundreds and hundreds.
Mm-hmm. What was going on? Was there masturbation involved?
Not in all cases. No. Just there.
Not in all there cases. Was
there,
I believe is what he said.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, he's back on the self-incrimination train. Not every instance, but certainly some genitalia.
There was masturbation in places of people who did have a connection.
There was masturbation in places with people who I did have a connection with. Of fucking course. it's always like using like emotional connection as like a way
okay.
to like a cop out. It makes it okay. It simply doesn't, Jim.
Okay. In other words, people who stayed with me in the more short term. No.
What about with Cheyenne?
Yeah, I don't think so. I don't think so.
Doesn't think so.
That may be just a. I don't remember, but I don't think so. Yeah, I don't think so. I think it was more like, you know, here's a guy's thing now. More that was more of it.
More of an education for her.
I think so. She was at least whoever she is. We go back to that.
Yeah.
You know, it was more of a
exploratory.
This is what a guy looks like.
Yeah.
Oh, your boyfriend.
Another
like
fucking
you.
Classic. Another fucking classic. This is what a guy looks like. Mr. Teacher over here. Doesn't really make you being a teacher look very good if you're trying to, like, teach this girl these anatomy lessons in your spare time. This is what a guy looks like. Fuck off.
This is what a guy looks like.
At this moment, do you think he's... does he believe he's going home when he said that?
In this moment, I don't think... he wouldn't say that unless he had like a little inkling of hope that he could still talk his way out of it, because he's still trying to. And maybe it's just like, you know, fight or flight. Maybe this is him, like, this is the only way he knows how to try to get his way out of this.
It's like the last rush of adrenaline.
Exactly. This is like his last little rush of like, maybe I can fucking get out of here. You know, I was trying to show her what a guy looks like, and he's like, oh, god damn it. That's it. That's the nail in the coffin.
That's not illegal, is it?
Yeah, no, that's not illegal, right? To, you know, show her what a guy looks like. He's an educator at the end of the day.
Exploratory. This is what a guy looks like.
Shins. Yep. Oh, I think you hit it right on the head. He thinks he'll make Bond, and then work in the next morning. So he thinks that he'll
okay. Interesting.
Boyfriend looks like, you ever touched that your boyfriend? Oh yeah, I touched him once.
Touched him once.
Nothing more than that.
Nothing
for her.
That
I remember.
Okay. And you said,
I'm starting to feel like David Gaffney is a Mike Pence sock account with all this pro Jim Roush talk. Our dear community member Mike Pence is a real Roush head. I'm starting to think this is just him. Jim will show her the way. Jim is a real man. Educate all over me, Jim.
Good
to see you. Good to see you, Mike Pence. Good to see you.
He said you only do that like 2 or 3 times. He said something else? Or?
Probably 1 or 2 times. No more than that.
Diabetes.
And then tonight, he said you were going to be for her and various issues, you know, because her son with her parents, and
she said her mother was working at the hospital and that she was free and I connected
and
I gave her my phone number.
Gave her your phone number,
which was a big step for me.
Oh yeah, big step. Good for you, Jim. Really get really putting yourself out there, man. I'm proud of you.
Number one, I didn't even know where she lived.
Yeah.
And then we followed through with that, and went that fiasco. Been driving home.
Right. How'd you find her? How'd you find her place there?
Luckily.
Did you get like a map quest? Or?
No, I had originally had a map, but when you're I spent an hour looking for directions. Whoever it is, they're crazy.
They were terrible.
Yeah, they were.
So, did you have to call her back, or
she called me? But then, obviously, that was.
Yeah, that's where you kind of asked where is this?
Well, where am I going? What am I doing?
He's dissing on the
was
people.
Was it a cell phone?
Gave him bad directions.
He said she said she gives bad directions.
Yeah.
Oh man! Wow, what a dickhole! Yeah, that's really mean, Jim.
Why don't you mention the vodka tonics you had before you put the key
yeah,
in?
Yeah, exactly. Come on, Jim. Let's not let's give credit where credit is due in terms of like what contributed to you driving in circles for like an hour and a half.
I'm not sure.
On your
cell phone. I had a cell phone.
So she was calling you on your cell phone?
Mm-hmm. Or whoever it was.
Yeah.
Okay. Have you ever called her on your cell phone or anything like that?
No, never. Not doing that. Okay.
And tonight, I know a lot of things. You wanted to express certain things. You wanted to... I'm trying to express your feelings, Jim.
Okay,
I'm trying to express your feelings.
Yeah, come on, Jim. You express your feelings. Just say it in your own words.
And because I want to get it right, I don't want to say something that's not right.
Okay.
And but tonight, you know, you wanted to see how she was emotionally, sexually.
Mm-hmm.
That were kind of where the condoms come into play.
Were the what?
Condoms she had on you.
I wanted to put them in my pocket, which I did last night also.
Yeah.
That maybe that should be noted.
Yeah.
I put the condoms in my pocket tonight.
Yeah.
If something culminated that it went that direction,
right, you want to feel to be safe?
Okay. The same reason why I had them in my pocket last night. In case of when I went to the swingers club.
Because you wanted to have sex. Because you wanted to fuck somebody. Jim. That's not a check in your column, Jim. Yeah, I had him in my pocket tonight for the same reason I had him in my pocket last night. Because I wanted to have sex with somebody.
But he's assuring them that he would only do it unless it was really special.
I know. So. Exactly. It has to be really special. You want to make that connection before you just give it up. Right, Jim?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Do you understand?
I would.
Of course.
Have them in that case.
And you protect yourself.
Number one, I protect myself. Number two, I protect the person.
Just like I said, you care about people. I can understand that you would want, like I said, you didn't want to hurt nobody.
Exactly.
And tonight went. In that direction, you were at least been prepared.
I was prepared if it did it when it came to that point.
Yeah.
Which did I really expect it to be there?
Did you want it to be there?
Oh yeah, I'd love to be there. only in the sense that I'm frustrated as hell.
I think he answered that question a little too quickly.
I know.
I can go down the list.
Up and down.
I can go down the list. It's been 2 weeks since I've had a...
Oh, good evening, adult girl. You came just in time. It's been 2 weeks since Jim Roush has, you know...
Up and down.
I can go down the list. It's been 2 weeks since I've had a... I'm frustrated as hell. But expectations of it being there. Not really anything else. And it really is an aggressive nature on my part. You know,
but you have feelings. I mean,
but what I'm thinking of is, okay, I'm gonna go over and meet her. What happened? Whatever happens, okay, it's fine. And then I'm thinking about, okay, well, I'm gonna stop over at Ryan's. after it's over with, maybe there's, do you know Ryan's? Ryan's is over. It's a bar over in Eastgate.
Rhino's is also the scene of the first big fight in Many Syllables comic book Clobbering Time number one, coming soon. I'm going to narrate some of the videos for that. It's going to be very exciting. So get ready for a nice fight scene between Clobbering Time and some thugs over at Rhino's.
You know, if this like that doesn't happen or. I'm ready. That's exactly what it is.
And I think things would have went. Say things would would have went differently tonight and we were not here. Mm-hmm. Do you think you could have had a relationship with Cheyenne? Do you think there was enough of a connection there that you could have a relationship with her?
I think it's too early.
But you did feel connected? You did feel connected to her.
I felt connected to her, but it was too fast.
Too fast?
It probably would have been one of those things where we sat down, have the iced tea, and I went home. And that's what's so bad about this, because that's where I was. Maybe she wasn't the same where, same area, but I, or whoever it is. But for me, I really was not trying to. It's not just predator trying to.
Jim, we've done went over that.
Okay, but the point is, you still think that there's some sense of that.
But Jim, if you made a mistake, I can handle. You made a mistake.
I did not contrive this girl into having sex with me. What I did was I tried to meet with her
to help her out.
To help her out in what she needs to do. She's going through some stuff with her. If that's really
and
true. And then I still go on with my life.
And that's different from a predator.
Yeah. I hope so.
You know, Jim. I see the difference.
Okay. Yeah. I hope so because I certainly
there's
not
a clear distinction there.
Okay. Well, I just I don't want that clapped on top of me. I've spent many, many years not keeping away from it, but being aware that it's out there and just being careful.
Yeah.
And then to fall on this is.
Well, you've not had any issues before.
No, not at all. But the thing is, music teacher, elementary school. There's magnitudes of shit out there for that, and things like this. If this had ever happened to me, I would be fired from West Claremont immediately, because of the fact that there is that stigma, and because of the fact that. I'm since retired, so that it doesn't matter. But you should know that. You should know that those qualifications that come along with that territory, and it's not just music teachers, it's the other teachers as well. Any male teachers in elementary grade.
And like I said, I don't consider you in that category. And while I'm here, is there anything? I don't think they expect I would find anything, but is there anything in your vehicle that I should know about? Anything?
I don't think so.
Would you mind if any of the officers would look through to see?
Oh, I've no doubt absolutely at all.
Okay, so you don't mind if they look through your vehicle?
If they fill up my tires with air.
Well, I don't. I will ask them.
Another classic. As long as you fill my tires with air.
Classic, Jim.
I
okay, so you don't mind if they look through your vehicle?
If they fill up my tires with air.
Well, I don't. I will ask them. I will ask them, but I don't know what you'll get.
The reason I say that is because my light came on. My air pressure is.
Well, I will let them know.
There is not a damn thing in that car.
But you don't mind them taking a
look?
You don't
mind them
searching?
Not at all.
You want me to go get those forms?
Yeah.
I don't do drugs. I don't do that kind of thing. I do drink, but
I'll be right back.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll be back.
I've had my drinks and I've done that share of that shit. I was a professional musician for years and years. Never did drugs anymore.
Never did drugs.
About the only time I could one experience. I'll share.
What?
Okay, I'll tell you. It was with my ex-wife. Mm-hmm. We were like, I don't know, three or four years married. We had a 30-year marriage. Mm-hmm. And she said, I want to try that pot shit. And so I made arrangements to get this pot from somebody. I don't know who it was. And
we had rolled these little cigarettes and stuff, and didn't feel a fucking thing, right? She took a one draw of this, and she got deathly sick.
I mean, deathly sick. I'm telling you, at the end of the whole evening, I had called the doctor, and I had taken her to the hospital.
So you had all night of just her idea.
Oh, God. That was one of the only two times. The other time was I was playing a New Year's Eve job in Ashland, Kentucky. And
it's so nice that Jim laughs really bad night at his partner's illness.
I know. She got deathly sick. So hilarious.
Help move some equipment and stuff, and they pulled me back and they took me to the hospital and they gave me a damn shot of morphine at that time in Ashland. I couldn't sit up with the piano. I couldn't play with shit. they had hired me for like $100 for that night, and I could just get that's my drug thing. I drink vodka. I drink a lot of different things, but probably a couple drinks a night.
You said tonight you just had a couple of vodka tonics.
And that's what I usually do. I usually come home, take a couple drinks, and just relax. And it doesn't matter.
Can I get home, just kind of relax a little bit?
And I do at home. I do, and until I get a phone call that says, "Hey, more." I'm sorry.
Jim, we're just talking here, and that's the main thing, you know.
I really have not done anything wrong here, except for follow up on something somebody else has provoked me to. And
you know, you like me to work.
I haven't done anything besides follow up on something that somebody provoked me to.
Yeah,
is a very long way of saying I'm a pedophile.
We talked about, you know, you have a thing, you felt a connection, you felt a need to help her.
Well, it isn't a real person, so what I do is I cut it off, which is like my apparatus anyway. Which is
but you thought it was, Jim. You thought it was.
Probably more detrimental than.
How often do you do that? Just every so often, or anytime you get close to somebody? Or...
I have somebody that's really close to me right now, but she just...
I love the cops pretending to care about Jim's emotional well-being in any way. It's very funny. And him, like, eating it up.
And it produces the exact effect they want it to have. You know,
oh my god, like, it on the nose.
If she would come close to me, it would be my euphoria. There are other people that I can... I was dating a couple one person up in Wilmington, another person dating. All online. And all legitimate and all real people. And I said, well, the real person I want to be with is right here. And so I sent these emails to these other ones and said, I'm sorry, I'm going to have to stop seeing because I really want to see this one person. She doesn't understand. That's hard.
It is hard.
Mainly because I know that she's the right person. Yeah. I mean, I was married for 30 years and it was the wrong person.
Yeah.
And I've known this person for probably 10 to 15
years. 10 to 15 years. Somebody you work with? Or?
No, actually not. It's somebody who I have had acquaintance with. And she's divorced, and everything's fine. She's got older kids. I have older kids. And she just is so scared. Scared of. Come on in. You're the same person that left.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Cool.
Put in a copy of it, so we'll have it somewhere to look at.
Okay.
Actually, the person I'm talking about is, and again, this is, you can take it for her. So she's actually a social worker.
Can I have a social worker? Sorry, I'm sorry to interrupt you guys. I thought you were chatting. I'll be right back.
All right. She's actually a social worker. She deals with sexual abuse.
Yeah, exactly, Bartek. Jim Rausch is so friendly. Why don't you just let him go? He's no threat to anybody.
No.
He knows exactly what you guys are doing, except for on medical aspect of it, so related.
Okay. This kind of helps people out too, you see?
She's now a supervisor. She's running for a job in all the ones with Marcus, right?
Faisal?
Yeah, job in I can't remember the agency. It's part of the state of Ohio.
Oh, okay.
Anyway, so she's working with them. She's working as a supervisor. She works with.
This is all relevant.
Basically.
Of course, none of this shit has anything to do with what's going on. 20% of what he's talked about tonight has had to do with the matter at hand. It's mind-numbing, honestly. Actually, you know what? I don't know if I want to watch the another hour of this. I think I might be done. Yeah, I think I might be done. I looked at the stream. I'm like, oh, it's been 3.5 hours. This motherfucker's going to be doing the same thing the whole time. And then he just sits in silence for 20 minutes. What was that?
I know how it ends, so.
Yeah, I think we know how it ends. Let me turn this music down a little bit so I can hear myself. That was a lot of fun, though. I enjoyed diving into Jim Rausch a little bit. That decoy call was nasty. Obviously, the interrogation's a classic. I really enjoyed that. And thank you for coming on and doing that with me.
Of course. I mean, I've listened to both at least 2 or 3 times already, and
I know, me too.
I noticed new things this time, so.
Yeah, it always happens that way. Little turns of phrase or stupid shit that he says.
Definitely.
And thank you guys for stopping by and hanging out. I'll be back tomorrow for a nice juicy Lorne stream. I got some fun stuff to play. A lot of Lorne being a piece of shit you've come to expect from Lorne. Appreciate you guys coming in and hanging out, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. You guys are great, and thank you, Kelp Pill, yet again. I'll talk to you soon as well. Have a good night, everybody.
Always a pleasure. Good night, everyone.
I'm going to play a little outro song.
Of the monster, evil.